Welcome.
Hey. Ladies and gentlemen.
Doing things a little different tonight.
We out here.
Apparently Vega's doing things different for the intro to the intro.
Yeah.
I like that shit. Whatever that is, I like it. It sounds like a... I don't know. It almost sounds like this. Listen, man, you remember when you were at the Science Museum back in the day and you put the quarter into that shit with the Tyrannosaurus Rex?
With like the arm to go and grab the thing?
Nah. The shit where you would put a quarter in the
Tyrannosaurus. Play it one more time, Vega.
All right, here we go.
Run it back.
Play it one more time.
Nice bass hits.
I was thinking it was like some spy shit, like some Carmen Sandiego type stuff. Word. We got to get out of here.
This is
quick.
Spy versus spy.
You know what I mean?
Oh, Mad Magazine.
On point. It up, bro. Yo, we got some guests in the building.
Hey.
You going to get some introductions?
Dude, here we go. I'm Vega here. We got Bonafide. We got Kung Fu Drew in the place.
The supervisor is present.
The supervisor is here.
Gentlemen, lean in. Let them know who you are.
Yo. Bring it in. We got Dro up in here.
Northside Dro up in here.
There we go. Who else we got in here?
Don Def in effect. What up?
Don Def in the building. We got North Cambridge up in here.
Representing heavy.
North Cambridge slid through.
We outside.
12-minute journey.
Backyard.
Backyard again.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Rocking a cardigan, bro.
We about to drop an EP, the three of us, called the Backyardigans.
We only got four mics, but we got five people. So if the audio's a little fucking janky, fuck you. All right. Oh, well.
We're leaning in for real.
Word up. Yeah, we got my folks in the building, man. This is my man, you know, Dro Man's in the house. My man, Northside Dro. This is my guy since kindergarten.
Friends of the show.
Friends of the show, for sure. Man, I know Dro. I know Dro Man. We were just talking. I know Dro Man since he was stealing Transformer figures from the kindergarten classroom. And I was like, Matthew, please don't steal that.
That's it.
Please don't steal that. Motherfucking Transformer figure. And he refused. And then my man Don Def, who I known since second grade when I was over at his crib. My mom sent me over to his house and I fucked shit up and got uninvited for life to his house.
Banned for life. Nah, not banned for life.
Nah. But these are my peeps. And we're in the building tonight. Don Def been blowing the fuck up, man. He's been going super hard recently, man, with his SKILLSET album.
Trying.
Yeah, the SKILLSET. We played some tracks off that, and the single that you had, very good, man.
Word. Thank you, man.
Yeah, man.
Which one? The one with Term and Rex?
I think we played that one, too.
Yeah, man. There have been several hard fucking hits off the SKILLSET album. And the SKILLSET album, it's a good thing we got Dro here, because the SKILLSET album was mostly produced.
Yo, lean into the mics, gents.
Yeah.
It was mostly produced by Northside Dro.
That's right.
But this dude, Don Def, been blowing up with that shit. I mean, the song you did with Ed OG.
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, that was from before, but yeah.
That was from before, but that was produced by Loman and Chairman Chow, and I was in the video.
Do you have something with Insight, too?
Yeah, I did. I dropped a single on Brick Records, which was produced by Insight. That was last year.
That was hot, too.
And that was dope. I was glad to work with him. That was dope. That was featuring ST Knack. Shout out to ST Knack. He actually just dropped the album with, like, West Side Gun.
Yeah.
Peace, big shit,
Peace
man.
Peace Fly God or something?
Yep. That was
He's
dope.
All over that album.
Yeah.
That was dope as hell.
For sure.
Yeah, man.
Shout out,
they got a collaborative album now.
Yeah.
ST Knack and fucking West Side Gun, which is a huge fucking deal.
And who else is on that? Stove God.
Yeah. Stove God's on Mad Tracks.
Yep.
Dope
but
then
I dropped the SKILLSET. I got a bunch of dope features on that. I dropped that this year, a few months ago. I got Rex, Terminology, Mr. Lif, Acro, Sammy Adams, MBS, and
a lot of Boston folks on
there. SKILLSET remix.
A hometown album, right?
Yeah,
there.
For sure. I was repping on that. So.
And the man
produced
by
Dro. You know
yeah.
What I mean?
Word. Mostly produced by Dro, but then...
I'm also on there, too.
Aha!
Exactly.
And a feature from Northside Dro.
We got an ill track called Keep It Moving.
Yep.
Fire.
And Supervisor, you had some stuff produced by Northside Dro last year, right? Like most of
so
your
So much,
too?
Man. Yeah, Cortez 3. Cortez 3
the
was...
The one with the doppelgangers.
Exactly. Yeah. So the whole album was produced by Northside Dro, except for three joints that were produced by the doppelgangers, you know?
Fire.
So,
all fire. Mandro's underrated. We rep.
But Dro. But one fact that I can't let leave overlooked, you know what I mean, is that me and Dro were the Hairline Brothers.
That's it. Oh, yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
I've known Dro for a long time. I remember going to his house
drinks.
Back in the day.
We got energy back drinks in the day, listening to beats. The house today.
Oh, word. I see the energy drinks in the building.
I forgot about the energy drink movement.
I do drugs. I don't energy. Need energy drinks.
Yeah. Wow. Energy drinks.
Yo, yep. Spit a little rhyme from that. I know you remember that shit. How does it go?
That's metal.
You remember
while.
It?
I don't drink Red Bull. That shit tastes dreadful. I do drugs, drink, and act disrespectful. If you need anything, I come to your rescue at any local pub or at the disco tech too. Anywhere you want it, I got it, and I'm going to give it to you. Yep. Any narcotic, the product, I'm going to sell it to you.
Fire.
That's how much you got, man. It's been so long that I've heard that track. I forgot about that.
I literally just told back. I told him he needs to re-release that, and it could blow up right now. Because
be
that
hot.
Shit went Why under not? The radar. That shit went under the radar.
It did. And honest to God, like, I could probably pitch that shit to, like, Barstool Sports or something and have that shit be the anthem of the year from them motherfuckers. You know what I mean? Because that was some ignorant shit.
Yeah. And now people are super ignorant out there. So yeah. they caught up to us.
It's just us having a fun time, you know?
It really was.
That's what it's all about, hip-hop.
For real. And that particular song literally was just the two of us hanging out having a good time one night. And Dro just started saying, I do drugs, I don't need energy drinks.
I don't think I have my shirt on either.
Nah, he never. Didn't.
I don't think he ever has it.
Motherfucker had his belly out and everything.
Belly of the beast.
Belly of the beast. Woo! Belly of the beast.
Ooh, the origin story.
Yep.
Right?
That's it.
Yeah, but
I was going to say, I first met Dro way back at his crib.
Way back.
Like, word.
Like well, two. Now, I don't.
Was that high school?
It might have been high school. Or like shortly thereafter. And that was, I didn't go there with you.
No?
It was
that's
just...
Oh, you probably went there with Ben Nice.
Might have been there with Ben Nice. It could have been just random.
Or a Fat Boy or something.
Fat
yeah.
Boy. Yeah, probably. I think it was Fat Boy. Boy. Yeah. And he hit me up yesterday, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
That's what's up, man. Yo, shout out Gordo, man. Yeah. Fat Boy's doing his thing.
Hit that shit,
Dro. Wow. It's getting crazy up here. But yeah, that was the first time I met him. And, yeah, that was a while ago. That was like 20 years ago.
Yo,
maybe longer.
Shout out Fat Boy, man. I haven't talked about this dude in a long time, but he's a fucking a true OG.
Yeah, man. He can spit, too.
And he can spit like a motherfucker, man. And not only can he spit, but the man can write good songs.
He's amazing.
He really is.
He knows how to orchestrate everything.
Remember when he was calling himself North Star back in the day?
Yeah.
And doing joints with you?
Hard Shell, right?
Hard Shell. Yeah, the Hard Shell Entertainment shit.
Where is he now?
I mean, he's back and forth, man. He's in Cambridge. Sometimes he's in Miami. Sometimes he's in New York. I mean, this guy's a mover and shaker. But he's a Northside original, man. Shout out Fat Boy.
Big up,
too. Yep. Big up, Fat Boy.
Word up.
And Don Def and I go way back, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Way back.
Yeah,
when he was putting out his first album, I created the website.
Yep.
And we put out the first album.
Was that Burning Bridges?
Burning Bridges through my website. So I created the webpage for him. He had you could buy the album off there. There was, you know, just a lot. You could download it, do all that stuff.
Yeah.
And that's going way back. And that's before, once again, didn't know him through you either.
Y'all made that connection. It's so crazy.
I just said that to him on the way over here.
Yeah.
Because we were talking, I was like, yeah, it came up. So I was like, yeah, I just know this cat from like online.
Yeah.
Zan back in the day.
Doing forums and all that stuff. Yeah. And I always had the music. So it was like, especially I had a lot of Wu-Tang music. Mm-hmm. And Don Def's a big Wu-Tang fan. So I always had the fucking connection for that shit. And then I really liked his music. And then he was like, oh, I'm from Cambridge. I was like, oh, okay. Let's do this.
Yeah. And it just so happened that this was my man's in second grade.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Crazy.
Yeah. Life is wild like that.
Hey, man, it's a small city.
Yeah, that's it too. Yeah.
But honest to God, it's more than that.
But it's a big world, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
It's funny how you gravitate towards the people that are doing the same thing that you're doing, you know?
Yeah.
You gravitate to, well, I guess not necessarily always good people, but you gravitate towards the same energy that you're putting out.
Energy
it's true.
Drinks.
You know, that could be good or bad.
Hashtag energy you know? Drinks. But it,
that's
but
why
it,
we don't do drugs.
Yeah, we do energy drinks.
I do a little drugs.
No, honestly, I'd rather do drugs. If y'all were to offer me drugs and energy drinks, I would take the drugs. But it is a wild coincidence. I mean, Vega, you've had your thumb in a lot of shit. Not like
the early blog.
Literally
early
yeah.
blog.
Yeah.
Early blogs.
No, but like, you, for real, man. I mean, this is what we... I always say that the cryptonline.com is the best website on the internet. It's been voted the best website on the internet 7 or 8 or maybe 15 years in a row.
Yes,
you know
us.
What I'm saying? But like, the reason why is because like all these cats have connected with each other through the cryptonline.com, and even cats who like lived down the street from each other who would never have known each other.
Yeah, and I'm also one of those types of, I don't ask for nothing. I just, whatever, I put it up there, and yeah, and I put up music that I like too. So it's like,
I remember years ago being like, so when are you going to make money off this? And you were always like, I'm not putting advertising on this site. Yeah, like, this is literally just for the love of the game.
Right. And that was the other thing too, because like the websites back then were all got fucking congested with ads and fucking shit going on.
It was
on.
Gross, man. And I can name like probably 5 or 6 different websites that I used to visit regularly to check out hip hop shit. And eventually it was just like, yo, this is played out. Like,
and it's
slowing my browser down. I gotta not visit this shit.
And I got nothing against it, but at the same time, it's like I'm putting up Don Def or Dro's or your music, and I'm making money off those clicks. I can understand. All right, that's whatever. But like, still, that's like,
it's a little bit gross.
You know what I mean?
It's a little bit gross.
You know what I mean? I'd rather have
to be trying to profiteer off of other motherfuckers' artwork.
That's the thing.
It would make sense if it was like bigger artists. You know what I'm saying? Bigger artists who are making a lot of money off it already, and then you could just.
Yeah, exactly. That's a little different. You know what I mean? But once again, I'm doing for underground MCs and producers and DJs and all that stuff. So it's like, I like to keep it like that. You know what I mean?
Been doing it.
But it's just funny how, you know, it's just been so long. You know what I mean? Like, how long ago did Burning Bridges come out? 2005?
Yeah. 07, maybe.
07?
Yeah.
So that's 15 years. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And we were talking, you know, a year, 2 years before that probably, too, you know? Mm-hmm. And he used to send me beats, too.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah.
And he had crazy beats back then, too.
I was literally just talking to Donnie about this, you know?
He's trying
because
to get me back.
I'm trying to get you back on your beat shit. But that first album actually had a fucking song with me and Dro and you on it. With our guy B Wiz.
What's the song?
Yep.
I forget.
The song with B Wiz. Remember that shit?
Oh, yeah. B Wiz.
Yeah.
He did his thing. Yeah. You still have that album?
Yeah.
I need to hear
Of course.
That.
I still have a CD of that. So B Wiz actually is our man from Cambridge who is the brother of Sammy Adams.
Yep.
Sammy Adams, who ended up blowing up and actually did a single with Donnie on his last album.
This is years before.
Yeah. And I remember that day when we were at Donnie's crib recording into a Radio Shack mic, right? Me, Dro, and B Wiz making the song together. And Sammy Adams came through.
Mm.
And B Wiz was like, oh, yeah, this is my little brother. And I was like, oh, peace, what's up? And he's like, oh, yeah, what's up? Like, I'm a producer and shit. I fuck with DJ Drama. You know what I mean?
Okay, yeah, yeah.
You know, like real drama.
Yeah.
The dude from Boston, he knew like Reto and fucking Bombshot and dudes like that. And I was like, oh, okay, cool, man. Seemed like a cool young dude. That was the one time I met him. Yeah. And then years later, he ended up blowing up on that frat rap shit, man, and making a huge fucking splash.
Yeah, that was a strange time, the frat rap. Like, that didn't really, it happened for like a year or 2 years, and then it just kind of fell off the map completely. Like, you had like Asher Roth, you had Sammy Adams, you had... I think there was another one too. I can't think of the name right now.
There was some other dude, but Sammy is a true hip hop head. You know what I'm saying? He found his own lane and he managed to like maintain a grip on shit.
He's dope.
I mean?
He dropped a hot verse on my shit. And
yeah,
the beat and Dro did the beat. So
was Chris Webby kind of like that? Same
He's
type
still
of
doing his thing too.
I would say Chris Webby was kind of like that. Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, as you say, like that Sam Adams and Chris Webby, especially too, like we're able to transition into, you know, just kind of realer shit. You know what I mean? Like, less of a niche.
Shout out Sammy Adams.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shout out to him. Shout out B Wiz, man.
Yeah, for sure. That's
he's
my guy.
Wiz.
He's a good dude, man. He's still out there. You know, he's a graffiti dude, and he still gets up heavy.
Word
so
up.
Shout out to him.
Word up. Supervisor, what you working on now?
Oh, man.
New shit.
Well, I got an album coming with, not an album, but an EP coming with D-Phrase. Nice. And y'all know D-Phrase from, he did actually a bunch of production on Oompa's.
Oh, okay.
Last album. And that's my guy, and I know y'all played a bunch of that shit.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, and she's nice. So my man D-Phrase, I got an EP coming with him. I got a single with King Arthur on that shit, who I saw last night. Shout out King Arthur. And then I also got a single dropping soon called Stepdad 2022, which is inspired by my man Vega.
There we go.
Who sent me a meme.
Fire.
I'm not the stepdad.
Exactly.
Up.
I'm not the stepdad. I'm the dad who stepped up.
That's what the meme is? I haven't seen this meme.
Oh, it's great. I'll send it to you. It's a good one. It's a classic.
But inspired the whole track? You wrote it right that second?
It's funny because I've been writing the song. I've been writing the song for like a month. And then he sent me the meme, and I'm like, all right, it's done.
I'm putting it out.
I'm like, you know what? I'm actually going to go even more ignorant.
And it was weird, too, because not only did I send him the meme, like, I think with the meme, I was like, you know what someone hasn't really done is, like, a stepdad track.
Yeah.
You know, and like, I think LP did, and Cage may have, but, like, not, like, a modern day, like, not from, like, the point of view of, like, being, like, I'm the stepdad, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Not, like, oh, I'm mistreated by the stepdad, you know what I mean?
Okay.
Like,
yeah. I am the mistreater.
And then I just happened to be, like, I said that to him, and he was like, yo, I'm writing this track right now. Like, it's happening.
That's that Vulcan mind meld, man.
I actually heard a preview of the stepdad track, and that shit's
shout out Chairman Chow, man, on the co-production.
The beat?
Yep.
What's up? Happy birthday to him as well.
No, it's just me and Chairman Chow.
I
just brought the sample through and was like, yo, this is how I want it to go. You know what I mean?
I got you.
But maybe we should touch on that, man. Shout out Chairman Chow. His 30th was last night.
Yeah.
They had the birthday celebration at Scope over there in Jamaica Plain.
Yeah, well, I rolled through pretty early.
Yeah, that's what's up, man. I'm sorry. I miss you.
Yeah, I got to see Grubby Paws. Said what up to Chow.
Mm-hmm.
Another dude came on. I forget who it was. I'm not sure if they announced the name or not. I wasn't paying attention.
Well, so they did a beat set thing. Grubby Paws was there, Vinyl Villain,
yeah.
Chef Bogey, my man Loman, who we did a special episode about, the interview with me and him, and Chairman Chow, and then Lightfoot as well.
Yeah, so a lot of people from
like
the,
so all the top tier producers were there. Exactly.
Dro wasn't there though. That was the real.
Yeah, it wasn't there.
We were missing one or two of the top tier beat makers.
Let's talk about this right now. Dro is like the most underrated producer in Cambridge.
It's nasty.
I'm gonna say it right now, and this is Don Def saying it. So listen.
Appreciate that.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Nice cosign there.
Oh, it's 100%.
And that might be a good segue because there was like at least an interesting development that took place over the last week where my man Dro got an unsolicited message request from like someone who's probably like one of the fucking top tier rappers that we've ever played on this show. Word. You want to talk about that?
I'll hold out.
You want me to talk about it?
Nah.
All right, we'll chill. We'll hold on to that. But one of the illest rappers that really exists in the underground game, like one of the top probably 5 or 10 underground rappers that exists in the entire world, man, reached out to Dro the other day with an unsolicited text message like, yo, your beats are fire.
That's what's up, man.
Yeah.
It made my day.
Yeah. And it's the truth.
Yeah.
And then hopefully that fucking creates a snowball effect. You know what I mean?
I would love to see it.
I would too. I support it.
Yeah. It's going to be some heat.
I already know.
Hey.
But, So, a couple other cats were there last night at the birthday party. King Arthur was in the place.
Primo Profit.
Friend of the show, Primo Profit. Hopefully soon a friend of the show. I'd love to have him on sometime.
It was a fucking dope show, man.
Yeah, but it was a dope get-together, man.
Nice little shop, too.
Yeah. No, it is a dope shop. And shout out to the folks at Scope, man. They're real, like, pillars of the community there in JP.
You can pick up the supervisor tape there with Chairman Chow, the cattle guard.
Yep, cattle guard is there.
And you can pick that up there. You can pick that up at mixunit.com.
Yep. And if you want a compact disc, you can.
Damn.
Bring it back.
They fucking with you, man. Is your shit on there too, Don Def?
Honestly, when you guys posted that shit, I looked and my shit's on there too.
All
shit's
your albums?
Whack.
My shit's on there.
Yeah, it's crazy.
My shit's on there.
That shit's mad whack.
I don't know if people are buying the shit on there, but my shit is on there.
Johnny, how are you, man? You over here now?
I'm pretty mid.
Yeah, you had quite a couple days for quite a weekend.
I'm not super, but I'm fine.
That's good.
I'm whelmed.
I appreciate you pulling it together for this, man.
Can't wait to crawl under my blankets when you all get the fuck out of here.
Jelani watched one of our favorite movies today. He watched Duel to the Death. If you've never seen that, check that out. It's also RZA sampled it on Wu-Tang Forever, which we'll get into that in favorite.
Now, is that a Shaw Brothers film?
No,
it's not.
It's a Golden Harvest joint, I think.
Ah, Golden Harvest. All right.
And you can hear the sample. As soon as it comes on, you're like, oh, yeah, I know that one. But it was weird. Like, I woke up in a funky mood.
Stop running up on all these motherfuckers with that whack shit. That's the beat they're playing in the background. Yeah. They're all talking shit.
Took the dog for a walk. Listened to Monkey Bars from Sean Price.
Oh, yeah.
That'll bring it back.
You know what I mean? So I was feeling better about myself when we were back. Like, you know, 45 minutes, hour later, I was like, oh, okay. At least I'm in a good mood now. And I don't know. I just couldn't shake I couldn't shake it. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
All day, you know what I mean? I just had like a shitty attitude for no reason.
Well, you had
and
a reason.
It was beautiful out. Man, how did that happen?
Well, it was, I have no idea, but like for some reason, and I was trying not to like take it out on other people. So I was like, I'm just going to stay home and
be
a fucking hermit. You know, I'm going to watch fucking violent movies to make me feel bad. You know, and it kind of worked.
I do that same shit sometimes.
Let me ask you.
Duel to the Death was amazing.
What are the joints on Monkey Bars? What are your joints?
Ooh, you know what? Which one really made me smile today was I Love You.
Okay.
When you know, talking about being in a relationship, you know what
that's
I mean?
That's a fucking amazing song, man.
It made me thinking about something else. I randomly saw a meme talking about Alfalfa, you know, writing a love letter to Darla and talking about, like, yo, even he knew the He-Man woman hater club was bullshit. He was like, you know, he's simping on the side, but he knew. He's like, if you got a girl and you love her, it's cool. Write that bitch a letter and tell her you love her.
Bitch, I love you.
You know what I mean? And the Sean Price song talking about how much he loves his woman is hysterically funny, but
cook,
like,
right? He had a line about you can't cook.
Yeah, Heineken for breakfast ass bitch.
Bitch can't cook. Fire. Man, that album.
Oh, shit, that was yesterday.
Yeah.
Shit's hot. Onion Head's on that, right?
Yeah.
Onion Head.
Yeah.
Boombayé.
Boombayé.
Yeah. But I remember they were doing a lot of tours around this area at the time. So we saw him when he was like that album was like 2 weeks old. And he was down in the Middle
That's
East
right.
downstairs.
I remember that
and
shit.
And it was bonkers. He had his daughter on his shoulders.
That shit was nice.
Sean P.
Yeah, that shit was awesome.
Wild. Wild. She could have been more than 3 years old.
Is that his best album?
Mm.
I mean, excluding Helter Skelter.
I think it's my favorite. I think it's my favorite album of his.
Yeah.
I don't think he has a better album than that, excluding Nocturnal.
Yeah, and excluding the Helter Skelter stuff. Yeah. I mean.
Oh, we're talking solo?
Yeah, solo. That's what I'm saying. Sean Price. Solo.
Yeah, I think either or.
I think for me, that other one.
Mike Tyson?
It might be Mike Tyson. That's the one with the Barbarian on it, right? And
I think so, yeah. Barbarian.
Yeah.
I feel like that one was shorter. I feel like we didn't get as many tracks.
You got a full-length album. Like that's like 14, 15 songs.
Mike Tyson?
Nah, Monkey Bars.
Monkey Bars, yeah, that was
Mike Tyson's has got a grip of music on it, too, though.
There's
something about the Alchemist beats on there. It's like...
The Barbarian
Pyrex?
Is also a Ninth Wonder. That's a Ninth Wonder beat,
Ninth
right?
Wonder, yeah.
Oof, it's crazy.
But
Shut the Fuck Up Part 2 is on there.
I'll say this, man.
Solomon Grundy with Ill Bill.
Barbecue
Sauce with Pharoah Monch?
That's a fucking fantastic song.
But listen, I will definitely give the whole thing a full listen to just to refresh
my
memory.
Have your girl suck my dick with blue cheese on my balls? Come on, man. Yo, that's a shout out to Reverend Bob Levy, I think.
But there's something to like the narrative around the album, you know? And the narrative around Monkey Bars was like, yo, this dude Sean was washed. Right? Like they fucked up their record deal. Magnum Force didn't do very well, and he was back on the streets doing whatever he had to do to survive. And he put together this album, you know what I mean, with some production from Ninth Wonder. And he just sounded hungry on that shit. You know what I mean? And something about that just like resonates for me. You know what I mean? Even if he did come harder on the other albums, like I have the impression that this motherfucker was more desperate on Monkey Bars. Those fucking songs are amazing to
me. An interesting thing, too.
As a result of that. And I think that just real quick, just to finish this, is that like there's a couple other albums that are like that. Like Doomsday is like that for me, right? Because Doom was at rock bottom. He had been in jail since he had got kicked off of Elektra. You know what I mean? And this dude put out Doomsday, and that shit just like has the feeling of desperation to it. And that shit is fucking amazing.
Yeah, and you had, you know, when Monkey Bars, the come up to Monkey Bars, it was interesting because the only people that was he was like really featured on was like Philly guys. So like High and Mighty had him.
Uh-huh.
Vinny Paz had him. Jedi yep. Mind Tricks had him. And then he did the Monkey Bars. Yep. And it was just kind of interesting that those were the dudes who kind of were like, oh, this guy is ill. We got to get him back on or whatever it was. You know what I mean?
Yeah, they the buzz yeah, up, they recognized know? The skill.
Well, everyone loved Helter Skelter.
Of oh, course, yeah, but I wonder if that...
Skelter and
I think that's Eminem's favorite album, Nocturnal.
I wonder if that gave him a little bit of a breath of fresh air also because of the music they were doing at the time.
Yeah.
It was more a bit of a, yes, a bit of a exactly. lively kind of like...
They dragged him into this underground shit. They were hell like, yeah, yo, come fuck with this grimy shit with us. You know what I mean?
Well, they were grimy. They were...
Absolutely.
They were underground who kind of cracked through.
And I think before Monkey Bars that Vinny Paz had brought Sean Price on tour, or when Monkey Bars dropped, they toured together too as well.
Around Donkey Sean Jr.?
Yeah, Donkey Sean. Yeah, yeah, the mixtape.
Donkey Sean.
That was a good one.
That's crazy. What was the last Helter Skelter album? What was the name of that?
Dirt.
Magnum Force?
Dirt.
No.
Dirt. Oh, Dirt.
Dirt?
The Incredible Rap
the
Team.
On.
Is that?
The
is,
on the cover?
I was going to ask this eventually, but is Dirt as good as Nocturnal?
Not even close.
Nah, but it's good, though. And it's Dirt, better than Magnum and, Force, I think.
And Dirt is an amazing album, but it's not close to Nocturnal.
Bro, right? I listened to Magnum Force the other day,
yeah,
too,
Dirt.
And that shit goes super
hard.
Holds
fuck
up
Batman
to
and Robin.
Day.
I'm Robin with
goes,
a Batman.
The beats are fucking crazy.
Holds
on
up
shit
to this
I
day.
I kind of slept on that because I always go to Nocturnal.
Mm-hmm.
But Magnum Force. No,
are you with me?
Yo,
throw your hands
yo,
in there.
Magnum Force was unfairly treated.
Wow. Super underrated.
Super unfairly treated. Yeah. That shit should have been gold when it dropped. Yo. That was a fucking amazing album.
They go stupid on that, yeah.
What was that?
Summertime album?
Yeah, Guns and Ones, right? That was the one with Method Man, right?
Throw your guns and ones.
Oh, man.
Dang, are you with me?
The Rock Nest, dude, had it fucking knocking on that.
Even
hell yeah. Word, I think I might actually have your yeah fucking Magnum Force tape at my crib.
I think my sister actually bought me that one year for Christmas.
Oh.
I was like, yo.
Shout out Aaron Tevlin.
Yeah.
Best present ever that year.
Yeah, that's a fucking good gift, man. That's a great gift.
She bought me, I think she bought me Bobby Digital before, too. That was pretty lit.
That was a great
yo, shout out too. Aaron, man.
She's great taste of music.
She's good people, man. She's good people.
First album, I was like, oh, shit.
You're up in there, you're listening to Domestic Violence. You're like, yeah, hey, she gave me this? Oh, yeah, shit.
That was the best gift ever.
NYC, everything.
Yeah, dude, that was a great album, huh? Let's listen to some music. Let's take a break for a second.
Bombs
here.
Like Mookie Blaylock from the outside.
Or the inside. Oh, yeah, fucking War Cloud was on that, too,
yo,
right?
Rest in peace, what's his
Doc
name?
Doom.
Doc Doom, yeah. Dr. Doom.
No shit.
He was nice.
We did an obituary on the website. His family shot us out. That was really nice.
No
though
shit, man,
yeah. I think we were the first people to get up on that. Good people, though. R.A.P. Doc Doom. Let's play some Helter Skelter.
Let's go. The original rap team.
Yeah.
Your sweatpants ain't got no pockets.
Everything is Helter Skelter. Every day that matter rain.
Oh, what happened? We're outside. It's weird out here.
Everything is Helter Skelter. The whole shit is upside down. It's all fucked up right now. Everything is Helter Skelter. They know shit is twisted. But they wonder why we all getting lifted. Everything is Helter Skelter. It's not just rock and ruck and all. Which only means to tell you everything is Helter Skelter.
Before we converted to Islam, house burglar, wake up and your shit gone. My life is a movie, better yet a sitcom. Planet of the Apes, I blame the cannon in your face, brr. Overstand the underhanded ways of Sean P. Set trap, get clapped like a nigga on Saw 3. Dirty Harry gun, the fold clap strong. Put a hole in you and your bullshit rap song. Man, my flow was so spectacular that Marshall Mathers be wishing I go back to Africa. Ha! Joke, I kid. Like I smoke my coke in the cig, you dig? Brr. I be the first to burst the heat, clown. Wrong math, niggas catch a universal beatdown. Sean is the best. You ain't a close second. Peep the bronze on his neck, bitch.
Y'all say they nice, we say they polite. Y'all like them though. Everything is helter-skelter. Rappers embarrassed to say they rappers. Rappers say they sell crack though. Everything is helter-skelter. Look, then how about fat chicks is in style now. Everything is helter-skelter. It's not just rock and ruck and all. Charlie Manson tell you everything is helter-skelter.
tall, real deep voice, and I serve you.
You ready?
Patience ain't only your virtue. That's you and your man's at the hospital. I rehearse you. Beat you out your shirt and your shoes. Punch your chin off. Or the pound put your face on your chest like Rick Ross, bitch boy. You niggas kills got in the way. Gun clear the lane like proactive clear Diddy face. You beefing, but you vegan when it's about to cook. Time to ride. Yo, bitch ass in the mirror like how I look. Like a goddamn snitch, like a clown, like you bout to go tell on somebody right damn now. What you told him, son? Overstand your underhanded ways. Understand my overhand right and break his face. I sent your posters, they can waste the space. This shit look like it suck like Macy Gray.
I like Macy Gray, but ignorance is what y'all like. Bar fights and shit.
Everything is helter-skelter.
That only mean utter confusion. Ass backwards, stupid, see?
Everything is helter-skelter.
All the herbs, the rich. How the fuck police still murdering niggas?
Everything is helter-skelter.
It's not just rock and rock and all.
From which only means to tell you everything is helter-skelter.
Hey. Bam.
That album was nothing to be fucked with.
Oh, that was a good one, man. Terribly rare one, as we say around here.
Oh. But you guys are going nocturnal.
No, nocturnal that, no, that's definitely that's definitely the one.
Ishkoshka. Sorry, but, man.
True. But, hey.
But Dirt is, I mean, for a comeback album, after what? Like, that was a decade later.
Yeah, at least. Right?
Right? Then the time they released their first album. That's a fucking incredible album.
I think they did the first one in 95, and this one came out in 2008.
Shout out Duck Down.
Hell yeah, man. And then Magnum Force was 98.
Yeah. Dro, I remember back around like 97 or so, hanging out in Lincoln Way.
Yeah.
With Ugly Eric. And bumping that Nocturnal album and getting high as fuck, man. Yeah. We was out there in the projects as young kids, man, bumping that Nocturnal album.
I'm gonna be honest, I don't remember.
I know.
But maybe, like, maybe it was that too high.
Because you were high as fuck.
Too high. Maybe. I don't know.
Yo, shout out Lincoln Way.
Let's get into today's topic here a little bit.
Yeah, man. Summertime.
Summer jams. We didn't prepare for this.
Before we do that, hang
on.
Yeah, no, we didn't prepare for that at all. So yeah, I'm happy that another thing happened right before this thing happened. You guys were discussing.
Go ahead.
The supervisor, Kung Fu, said something about ever since somebody passed away, this person has the best hip-hop boy.
Okay,
what was that statement that you made?
Let's get into that.
Best. Do you remember what you said?
Oh, yeah, the best voice in hip-hop.
Yeah, what was that exactly? What did you say exactly?
So what I said
I heard
was,
it, and I was like,
Well, no, since...
This could be a good debate.
Since Guru passed away...
Who do you think had the greatest rap voice?
In my opinion, the undisputed best voice in rap music is Scarface.
Okay.
Ooh.
Wow. Number one?
My bad.
Number one. His voice his voice is absolutely fucking incredible and iconic.
All right, I got you.
You know what I mean?
I got
the same way
the
Guru's was, okay, except Guru's dead
this.
Now.
Let's go around and everyone says the number one.
Hold on, but wait a minute, because I think this was important here, because Don Dev said, wait a minute, you mean since DMX passed away?
I said DMX, because you said... Because I thought you meant like recently, you know what I'm saying? And
nah,
then you said Guru,
but
like
I never
Guru passed
I,
like a long time ago.
But DMX,
just, I thought you meant like recently.
DMX is a he had an amazing fucking voice and an iconic voice. But I never considered him. I don't know. That's just me sleeping, I guess.
Nah,
because DMX does need to be considered.
Hold on a second.
Yeah,
let's go here. Hold on. So you got Guru, right?
No, but he said Scarface.
You think Scarface is a greater voice?
Since Guru died.
No, but let's say from the top. Guru's your guy.
Guru was my guy.
Don Def.
It's
who's
mostly
your
the voice.
Best rapper voice?
Yeah.
Alive right now?
No, just in general.
Just in general, of all time.
I could give you a few.
Yeah.
I can't pick one.
All right, give me a couple.
I'll give you my favorite, or who I think. I got like Ghost.
Okay, yeah.
Prodigy. And maybe it's either like Method Man,
This isn't fair, man.
This like Meth or Ray, because they're like anytime they kind of just
and you kind of know what's them
so
right?
Well, you know what I'm saying?
I say like Nas or AZ.
Nas or AZ?
Nas, definitely.
Like the Queensbridge sound.
Prodigy, like Prodigy on Hell on Earth. Like, I just feel like that right there was kind
of
like.
Jelani, what are some of your favorite rap voices?
Well, this is, I don't really understand the question. Like, as far as like the voice that I enjoy hearing the most, or like the style of rap that I enjoy the most.
No, it's not about the style.
Most, or the most unique style of rap. You
no,
know?
It's
like,
not about their style. It's just about the voice.
Like, the coolest. Most, like, who
it's
you think
all
sounds
about the voice.
The coolest, you know what I'm saying? Or the voice you like the most.
And why is it Nori?
Is it Nori?
Honestly, it could be some days. It really could be.
On some days it could be.
And like, you know, it could be Cameron someday, but like I was thinking like the most unique kind of voice. Like I listen to E-40 and get lost in that shit all day.
Absolutely.
You know,
40's up there, top but five.
For me,
honestly, it's got to be. Yeah. We're all biased because we're East Coast dudes, but like I feel like, I don't know, it's something like a. It's got to be like a Nas kind of, dude. Ransom's been killing me lately.
Yeah, he's got a good voice.
I don't know, man. There's too many to choose from. But then I like fucking like I don't know. I like a lot of West Coast dudes too.
I'm telling you though,
me,
man.
Slick
for me,
Rick. He's just got the voice.
I like
he's got the sound. He's slick.
I was gonna mention KRS-One, but I don't know if anybody else really does it like that.
I would say Big Daddy Kane too.
Man. See, okay. Yeah. We're just gonna leave out like the greatest rappers of all time. I don't want to have this debate.
I
but
can't,
you're right.
Guru is one of the greatest of all time.
Gurizzy, for
but,
real.
But you could say Kool G Rap too, man, because his lisp was so unique. You know what I mean? And the motherfucker was so good at rapping.
And it sounded buttery when he did it.
Exactly.
What about Mr. Eon?
No, Mr. Eon got a great voice.
I'm not even
but
fucking around there.
You're not. But like at the end of the day, Scarface is my choice.
I used to like Cage's voice a lot too.
Oh yeah.
Like when it was like.
Movies for the blind.
Yeah, exactly. That like weird like fucking. He sounded like a duck.
But I mean like Biggie iconic voice. You know what I'm saying? He jumps on the track. You know, Biggie.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like his voice and Pac. You know what I'm saying? Like the super like. You know what I mean? Like top five dudes, their voices are important as fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like Big L voice. To me, Prodigy, like, I don't know, his something about the Mobb Deep albums. Like, you can't really sleep on that.
Yep.
Like, that shit is like.
I can listen to Prodigy.
You know what I mean?
I can listen to Prodigy while I'm brushing my teeth and have a great time.
I was listening to HNIC. Now it's back on streaming.
Mm-hmm.
I'll probably music
just
is back
put it
on
back.
Streaming.
Yeah.
And I've been going
it's a wonderful
hard,
thing.
Just going back because I know his shit.
That's all Jelani's
all
been
time.
Listening to for 2 months.
HNIC I've been doing
two.
That with Albert Einstein.
Yo, Albert Einstein, mm-hmm. word. But HNIC 2.
I've been saying
crazy,
that's my
bro.
Shit. A, B, C.
Crazy.
One, two. And it's all Alchemist, I think. And it's just fucking like the. And that was like kind of the comeback for Alchemist, which I've said before. Like,
yeah.
That shit
you think
was
that
crazy.
Was the one?
That was
how he reestablished himself.
I think so.
Mobb Deep put this. Put them on, you know what I'm saying? They put them on, and he always says that too. So, but that album is incredible, HNIC 2.
And
love that
we were talking about that as far as like summertime albums. I was gonna say like Mr. Cheeks and Lost Boys in particular.
Summertime in the city,
It's like distinct voices and summertime shit. Like,
that's
I just
illegal
that
money. One of
the sound
best ever.
Yeah.
That is one of the best summertime albums ever. If we're going to get into our topic here,
love, peace, and happiness. Yeah,
that's just it. Reminds me of the summer, all the way through.
Super dope.
Crazy features on there too. It's just like, oh shit, they actually ripped that verse too.
And I think you mentioned it too, Beast from the East.
Yeah,
with Cannabis.
Yeah, Cannabis rips that shit.
I think Cannabis was like two or three tracks on that album.
Yeah, he was down with them.
What about Onyx too?
Onyx, of course.
Yeah,
Shut Him Down.
Yeah, that was a summer one. Was that a summer one?
Shut him down.
I don't know if it was summer one, but we was bumping that the whip heavy.
That would get
heavy.
You hype.
Heavy.
Any fucking season, I'll get you hype.
In the summer.
I love that album on a cold, rainy night.
It's dirty.
I love
so
that.
It's cold.
That Shut Him Down.
I think it's more cold. You know what I'm saying? I think that's more winter for me.
You know,
personally.
You know, somebody might get hurt when they listen to that album.
That shit's too hard. That's one of the hardest albums. I posted that. I was talking about. I made a post about that. I don't know if it was like an anniversary or anything, but sometimes on my IG, I just be posting, you know, CDs that I have.
Yeah.
Just
your collection.
Like, you know, give a shout out and just talk about them. And I did Shut Them Down a little while ago. And I listen to that album a lot. To me, that shit is. Like,
we do too.
That's a crazy album. And that's probably their best album, interestingly enough. You know what I mean? Like, not a lot of great rap groups.
They have good concepts, too.
Well, not a lot of great rap groups hit with their third album being their best album ever. Usually it's their first or second album. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Oh, that's a good point.
But they had that three-album run, though. That's crazy.
Exactly.
Great point.
And then they hit with Shut 'Em Down, and it was like, wow, okay. So, okay, Onyx, this is your best album yet. Yeah. And y'all motherfuckers have been... They had Slam.
All we got was Us was incredible.
Yeah, Dro loved that one.
We did an episode on
So Your Gun's in the Air.
One of my favorites ever.
Yeah. Yep.
They're so ill because they came out so early that by the time they dropped our favorite album from them. What was that, like 98?
Yeah, 98.
That's the fucking prime time.
Shut them down, 98.
That's prime time.
All we got was
golden
was
era. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, remember when we did the episode on the fucking
Survival of the
Def Jam Survival of the Illest shit?
Yeah.
I mean, that was a crazy fucking time. These dudes, you know, not only did they have all these, like, well-established Def Jam artists, but they had fucking Core Mega.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Mega for a second. I like this. I like this little segue.
Yeah.
Let's go. I love Mega.
Because dudes went from, okay, Mega's on fucking Def Jam, and he's dropping shit, and he's on tour with these cats, to Mega is nowhere, and he's done, to Mega is on fucking Land Speed. And he drops the biggest record Land Speed has ever had.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, independently.
Independent.
And makes hundreds of thousands of dollars off that shit.
Yo, shout out to him.
Shout out to Mega, man.
That was The Realness. Yep. Then he did True Meaning.
The Realness.
Then he did Legal Hustle.
Yep.
Then he put out The Testament, which is not, you can't stream it anywhere right now, which kind of sucks. I'm not sure if it's like falling into a weird spot.
Yeah, that was the shelved album, right?
Yeah, exactly.
That's right. That's the album that Def Jam shelved.
He finally put it out.
Yeah, but it's weird you can't stream it anywhere now, though. I wonder if he's having like issues with like sample clearances.
He might not own that shit.
He might not.
He might not have any rights to that shit. I don't know. That's a dope album, though.
It's so funny, really, man. Yeah. When cats get shelved, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like,
you can't do nothing about it, too.
Well, so sometimes you get shelved, and they're like, "Yeah, we're holding the rights to this, and we're never putting it out," right? And so you're just like stuck, like your product is done. But there's certain weird circumstances, like with MF Doom, you know what I mean? They shelved him with the second KMD album, but they were like, also, like, we're gonna give you this album, and you can walk with it, do whatever you want with it. And
well,
then MF
probably, there was probably a lot of shit that went into that.
Like, and then MF Doom went through several years of whatever the fuck his life was, you know what I mean? Went to jail, did whatever his thing was, and then finally re-released the KMD album.
Yeah, but he probably had to go through a lot of shit to get that, the rights.
Nah, they straight up gave it to him. They were like, you can walk with this. They were like, we're not putting this album out, and you can walk with it and do what you want with it.
Okay. I figure there probably is some other... It more went into that, but yeah, I'm glad that happened. You know what I'm saying?
I'm glad that happened too. I mean, that's just a bizarre circumstance. You know what I mean? Because I know that Core Mega didn't get the same leeway with Def Jam. Word. It took him a long time to get the Testament back.
Word. What's y'all favorite Mega album?
By far, The Realness.
The Realness.
By far, The Realness.
Okay.
I feel like the first time, like that first impression, is always the best one. I feel like that's what that did that for me.
Yeah, The Realness is crazy.
True Meaning is crazy too, though.
Yeah, he got.
I think The Realness was the first time I was, you know, initially like, oh wow, this dude is about it for real.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I mean, so I may have told this story before on this show, but I'll tell it again. But like, during the time when The Realness dropped, Murder Music was the biggest thing.
Mm-hmm.
For me and the people I was hanging out with, and Dro can testify to this, but like, we were hanging out a lot during the time when Murder Music came out. We were in the Clarendon Hill Projects a lot. Clarendon Hill Projects in Somerville, just right over the border from Arlington, and all dudes would listen to was Murder Music.
And he's on What's Your Poison.
That was it. All dudes would listen to was Murder Music.
And he's on What's Your Poison.
Yeah. And then when Core Mega's album dropped, it was like, oh, okay, we can listen to this too. You know what I mean? And that was the shit. Like, dudes would be booming this out of their boombox at the park. You know what I mean? And that shit just, I don't know. It was weird to have an album hit like that, that was coming out on an independent label that was a Massachusetts label, right? Land Speed was coming out of Quincy at the time, right? And that kind of changed. I don't know.
It was dope.
In a lot of ways, it changed people's perspective on shit. Because we had friends who were working at Landspeed when that album dropped, right? K to I was working there. Floyd was working there. Karma was working there, right? Shout out to all these dudes. And they were there at this record label when this dropped. And it was the biggest record they had ever dropped. And also, you know, it wasn't some niche fucking underground hip hop shit. This was some shit that was hitting in every hood.
Yep. That was like the biggest underground independent record of all time. I think he sold the most, right?
I think that's down in history. And he boasts that.
Yeah.
That this is the number one independent hip hop record of all time.
Yep.
This dude basically sold platinum off that shit. Yep. It wasn't a million records, but like he sold so many.
He probably made more money than
exactly.
You know what
he made
major
platinum
artists.
Money off that shit.
Yeah. Fine. That shit's crazy. That song Three with Prodigy is like super classic.
So shout out to Landspeed and whatever they became after that, you know?
Yeah.
But it was cool. Dro, did you ever come out there with me to Quincy?
I don't believe so. No.
Because I used to go out there every now and then to Quincy. Nick, my man Simon Bar Sinister, Crass, right? And then
what was that name again?
Simon Bar Sinister.
Wow.
Simon Bar Sinister.
Yep.
There's a lot going on there.
Yeah.
Sounds like a fucking supervillain.
Nah, and he is. He's an old school Somerville cat, good friend of ours, and then friend of the show, right? And then K to I, and then my man Sir Pyro, aka Floyd, they all worked for Landspeed at the time. And so if you had a whip, you could drive out there to Quincy to the warehouse, and they would just hook you up with free shit. And they were all working there at the time when that record dropped.
That's dope. I think Mega's about to drop. I mean, he keeps talking about the realness too, so hopefully that shit comes out. He's been talking about that for a few years, I think. That'd be dope. You know what I mean? I like the part twos. What's the best part two, you think?
Cuban Links?
Yeah, Cuban Links.
I would say so.
Fire.
That's a good album.
Yeah. Cuban Links 2, super fire.
What's another summer anthem? What do you think?
Well, you got to go with Fresh Prince, right?
Album.
Oh, album.
Yeah, like what's the number one summer album?
It's got to be something by Jay-Z, right?
I mean, Reasonable Doubt is super light, you know what I mean?
I might leave Love, Peace, and Happiness right up there.
That came out in the winter though too, which is kind of strange. And January.
We'll debate based on that. Like, which album makes you feel more summery than that album?
You could maybe like think of some like Tribe Called Quest maybe or something like
that. I think this is a great conversation, man.
What about like I'm trying to think of like because I think Summertime. I think of that Spike Lee joint with fucking. They played that Public Enemy song the whole Fight the Power three times during that movie.
Yeah, Do the Right Thing.
Yeah. So I get a good Public Enemy vibe during the summertime. Public Enemy.
So being an East Coast dude,
what do you got?
My favorite summertime album is E-40 in a Major Way.
Is that the one you had with you last week?
Why did you say being East Coast, dude?
Yeah.
No,
because that's how much he loves it. Because that's how much he loves it.
No, because, you know, like, when you're dealing with West Coast albums, it feels like every West Coast album is a summer album.
I could see that. Yeah, because it's got that.
Based on the climate is always sunny and beautiful there.
Basically, yeah. I mean, like,
Southern California.
Because some of my favorite East Coast albums are like, to me, they're clearly wintertime albums.
Okay. A little bit darker.
Liquid Swords?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a wintertime album.
Right?
Yep.
I feel that.
Enter the Stage?
I know what you're saying.
The first Black Moon album?
More darker and colder feel.
Exactly. Even Muddy Waters.
Yep.
Oh, man, that's like a summertime one.
You think
that has a lighter Muddy Waters has somewhat a lighter. The production was a little lighter. It was kind of upper.
What's that other one he had? The other one.
There is a dark side?
No, Doc's the Name.
Doc's the Name. Now that's a summertime album. Yeah,
they both were.
You think so?
I think
you
so.
You think Doc's the Name?
I think Doc's the Name.
I love it. Don't get me wrong. I do love the album.
I know.
Best Red Man is Muddy Waters.
Like mine is for me. There's a Dark Side.
Five. You like that more than Muddy Waters?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bold statement, I know, but I love it.
No, but I respect that.
Interesting.
Because I'm almost there with you.
He said switching up speeds like Bruce Lee
riding
the
Fuji in the movie. I drop it on the one, fuck the 2-3.
Yeah, that shit was fire.
Funky like a box of Coogees on Bruce Lee.
Yeah, he went crazy.
We got to do a whole last Red Man episode.
We do got to do a Red Man episode.
One of my favorite summer albums is Wu-Tang Forever. Came out in June 1997.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Listen,
Triumph
man.
Was the hit that summer.
Oh, you're right, man. Yeah. That was all over MTV.
That was the hit. Yeah. It was the most expensive video when it came out.
That's right, the million-dollar video.
We skipped school to get the fucking shit like 2 weeks before the end of fucking, before Christmas break. It was just like, that was a whole movement right there, and that whole album bumped through the whole summer.
Yep. Yo, I know this dude, I know Dro can relate, because, you know, out in Walden Square, that summer, it was nothing but Wu-Tang Forever bumping out of everyone's window.
Yeah. One of the best albums ever.
Killer Army, incredible. Too. Killer Army.
Quiet Weapons for Silent Wars.
Yeah, that was bumping heavy.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's dope. Yo, but if you think about, let me just say this. My pick would be something like Doggy Style.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
that's
think,
a solid
yo,
pick.
You know
for
why?
Because
I was fucking chilling probably like 5 years ago or whatever. I mean, it's one of my favorite albums in general, but I was chilling like on a lake house just hanging with, you know, some of my boys. And we were just like, we put that on and it just felt so fucking good.
Right. It was
we
just right.
The whole shit. We were just drinking on a lake house shit, just vibing. Mm-hmm. It just felt so good.
Yeah.
And that
man.
Hit perfectly. The whole shit, you just let it bump and it just feels great.
Let right. it ride.
That album is fantastic. I was actually just listening to it last weekend.
The best.
And I'm like, every track is amazing.
It's incredible. Bro.
There's not
every
one
track,
weak song on that fucking album.
Every track is a banger. And I'm like, damn. And then it like, just looking at like the vinyl, the album cover is just like, oh, now I know why my mother didn't want me to, you know.
Yeah.
I yep. get it. But it's so funny that, so I was going to mention the summer I moved to Arlington, it was before fifth grade. And I remember just like walking around, getting like around the neighborhood, seeing what was going on. I walked down the basketball court by where I live, by the high school, and dudes were playing The Chronic. And I was like, oh shit, do you guys listen to this too?
Yeah.
I was like, oh, wait a minute. This music is down here? You guys actually know this shit? And I was like, okay. I think you guys are going to be my friends.
That's what's up, man.
And oddly enough, it was our old friend who passed away, Anthony Cianci.
Rest in peace.
Oh, man. Yeah. Rest in peace, Anthony Cianci, man.
I remember when I first moved to Arlington.
He was one of the first people I met when I moved to
Arlington.
Yo,
real talk, man. Anthony Cianci was a motherfucking institution.
He was a
fucking
one-on-one.
Mayor. I remember when I first moved to Arlington. This is 1990.
Shout out to Cianci, brother.
1993. And I rolled up, and I was, like, real into metal. Metallica, Anthrax, fucking Megadeth, all that kind of stuff. And punk rock, you know what I mean?
Of course.
And I roll up, and I was, like, the coolest kid in school in California. Like, and everything was all about metal back then. And I rolled up, and they were like, dude, what the fuck are you? And I was like, y'all don't listen to Metallica? They were like, fuck no. And I was like, what do y'all listen to? And they were like, Dr. Dre. And I was like, okay. I'm like, I know Dr. Dre just from N.W.A., but I had no clue about The Chronic. Like, that like, totally missed me. And then they were like, Snoop Dogg. And I was like, who the fuck is Snoop Dogg? I never heard of Snoop Dogg before. And I'm from that area.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it was, like, really weird to me. And I remember going home, and I was like, Mom, we got to get Snoop Dogg and Dr. Dre tape. And she was like, nah. She was like, nah, we're broke. You ain't getting shit. But I was like, no. I'm like, these kids don't listen to Metallica. I'm like, you don't understand. They're like, if I don't have this, it's just gonna be. I'm over. I'm already bad enough.
I'm done.
I'm wearing Vans, and they had never seen Vans before. And they were like, yo, what the fuck are those on your feet? And I was like, yo, these are Vans. Y'all don't fuck with Vans. They never heard of Vans. They were like, those are Bobos.
You were Eddie from Stranger Things.
Yeah, I was essentially like, I look like Eddie Furlong is like what I landed, and T2 is when I rolled up. Like it was. And I had the Anthrax jacket with fucking. He was way cooler than me. Way cooler than me. He could fucking, he could bust open an ATM machine with an Atari 800. Come on, yeah. Get out of here. He was fucking dispensing cash with a fucking Atari.
Fucking Budnick was the lookout.
He was. Fucking shit. What a great movie T2 was.
Still one of my favorite movies of all time.
Snoop Dogg is like a really good for summertime, though. Doggy Style isn't streaming, though, on Spotify. I was going to play that W Balls joint. What's your favorite song off
W Balls?
That's
W
not Balls, streaming, dude.
W no. Balls.
Really? Oh, I'm so happy.
What's your favorite,
I bought that out of Idol.
What's your favorite track off that one?
When I Met You Last Night, Lady.
Oh, yeah. Is that your favorite joint?
I think so. It just makes me smile every time I hear it. It just makes me so happy.
This might be controversial, but my favorite song off that whole fucking album is the La Di Da Di cover.
Really? That's a good one.
Because it's different. It's not La Di Da Di. He flips it.
That beat is so delicious. Sick.
The beat is delicious.
Yeah, man. Dro, what do you think? What's your favorite song off of Doggy Style?
I think what Jay said.
Oh, you fuck with him?
Yeah.
Nah, he didn't hear it. It's a tough question, though, because that album is top notch, you know?
Yeah.
For me, it's Keys and Hustlers.
I don't think there's a skippable song.
Then there's not. There's not.
The beats were all amazing.
The beats were crazy.
Incredible.
But you know what? That's a fantastic summertime album for cats who are from the East Coast. You know what I mean?
I love that shit.
All right, hold on. I got something for you, too. Okay. So just thinking of that, right? Like, that was very influential. Then I was thinking about summertime albums and something that I bought when that came out in the summer was Funkified by Da Brat.
No shit.
And that had like, she's from like, I think she's from Chicago. Then you have JD.
I think she's Atlanta.
Atlanta?
Yeah.
But then that whole sound was like wicked, like West Coast sounding. Like it sounded like G-Funk. You know what I mean?
Sure. They were swagger jacking hard.
Oh, they made a whole career. I mean, because that whole
JD
family.
Made a whole fucking.
So this is Da Brat right here, but it sounds like it could have been on Snoop.
Yeah, some Funkified shit.
JD had beats back then, though. What's that? What'd you say?
Did he make them?
Oh, yeah, he made the beats.
You know who had some little beats, too? Hammer.
Hammer? Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, some slappers.
Talk about it.
Wait, what?
Hammer.
That's good summertime music, too.
Tell me more. Was Hammer making beats? I'm just curious.
He had some beats like this. I heard some song like that. I think it was Hammer and Deion Sanders.
For real?
You remember
what?
That?
What the fuck? No, I don't. Tell
and you were like, damn, that's your slap.
That was L. Deion Sanders is rapping? Oh, my God. That was fire.
I
got
to get on that.
That's fire.
All right, who's the best? Okay, then. Who's the best athlete rapper, then?
Maybe that was Shaq.
Maybe it was
Shaq. That's what I'm saying. Shaq was the best. Shaq was the best.
Man.
Shaq had a track with RZA and Meth, right? No Hooks.
Yeah. KRS-One.
Yep. He had a song.
Is Jelani looking it up right now? He's looking up. You looking up Hammer and Deion
or whatever? What was the one with Biggie?
I might be mistaken.
I don't think you're mistaken.
He had a song with Biggie.
Sounds right.
Can't Stop the Rain, right?
Who's that? Shaq.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can't Stop the Rain.
That was fire.
Yeah.
Incredible. That was a good one too.
Incredible.
Yeah. Damn.
Shaq is the.
Shaq had one with Method Man too. Remember the Batman joint.
Yeah, and RZA too.
Yeah.
That's why I said no Hooks. That was the first
one. Okay, yeah. Sorry about that.
Yeah,
shout out
Shaq,
Redman.
Bro. He's a
hip hop
head.
Shaq,
for
what
real.
What about Allen Iverson?
Shaq.
He could spit, right?
Nah, yeah, you know,
the same, though.
But
I don't know.
Was Sprewell a rapper too?
I think he was.
I don't know. I just don't know.
Dana Barrows earlier.
Yeah, that's right. Shout out Dana Barrows, man.
No one did it like Shaq, though.
First Boston rapper ever to have a fucking feature. Beat from DJ Muggs.
It was John
Shout
Cena.
Out Muggs. Shout out Muggs. We need to connect. Holla. I'm just sending it out there. Don Def.
Send it. Sorry, no clarification on the song with Deion Sanders. MC Hammer may have done a song with Big Shaq, if you guys remember him.
Brrrah!
Mine's not hot.
Mine's not hot.
Quick maths.
I don't know about this.
Skidapoom poom poom.
I do not know about this.
What?
You don't know Big Shaq?
Oh, please. Can somebody look it up for him? My fingers don't work that fast anymore. You don't know Big Shaq?
I don't think so.
It was a phenomenon for a few summers ago.
He was
actually
a British cat, man. This motherfucker was. First of all, he's nice.
It was a few summers ago. Veg, you want me to do it?
I got it. Keep going. Keep talking.
It was probably about 3 or 4 summers ago, and it fits properly into our topic of summertime songs.
It was a summertime jam.
But it was just ridiculousness, and people like were like, "What the fuck is going on here?" But like, people thought it was real rap, and really dick riding this dude to like a little bit of fame. He had like more than 15 minutes. He had like 25 minutes.
He got 25 minutes of fame,
right, at least. You know what I mean? Right. On some just like joking dumb shit. But it got hot.
Your man's not. He got very hot.
Mine's got hot.
Okay, boom, Big Shaq. Ota a sneak, scoop no, rat no, usna, ota the girl them as well. Boom, 2 + 2 = 4 - 1, that's 3, quick maths. Everyday man's on the block, smoke trees. See your girl in the park, that girl was a uckers. When the ting went quack, 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 you man were ducking. Ota a sneak, he's got a pumpy. Ota my man, he's got a frisbee. Trap, trap, trap on the road, moving that cornflakes, Rice Krispie, all time my girl Whitney.
Perfect.
On the road doing 10 toes, lama toes, you man thought I froze, I see a pen girl then I pose, if she's not on it I ghost, ha, look at your nose, what, you dick her, look at your nose, nose long like garden hose, shh, you get me? Boom, man's gonna come back in.
Yeah.
You know like that?
Yeah,
you're feeling that?
Yeah,
you're done now. I see you shivering in that. Don't get shook, man's air. You're protected. All right. Yeah?
All right,
boom. Let's go. Boom. Hop out the 4-door with the 4-4. It was 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chilling in the corridor. Your dad is 44. And he's still calling man for a draw. Let him know. When I see him, I'm gonna spin his jaw. Take man Twix by force. Send man shot by force. Your girl knows I've got the sauce. No ketchup. Just sauce. Raw sauce. Boom. Yo. God. The thing goes grrrr up. Pop, 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 pop. Skiddy kick, pop, pop. And the poop, 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 boom. Skia. Toot, toot, coot, coot, boom, boom. Boom, boom. You done know. Big Shaq. Yo. Yeah, yeah. All right. Fire in the booth. You get me? Man's not hot. I tell him, man's not hot. Ha, cut. I tell him, man's not hot. The girl told me, take off your jacket. I said, babes, man's not hot.
Yo, man's not hot.
Man can never be hot.
Man can never be hot. It's a satire, Don Def. It's a goof.
Okay. That motherfucker is nice.
Nah.
Yeah. There was some shit. Conway had dropped a new album, I think.
Oh, with Big Ghost?
Yeah, with Big Ghost.
Yeah, man.
And that was pretty dope, too. There was some kind of interesting thing I heard on it, though. Hold on, let me see if I can bring it up.
Shout out to Conway.
Shout out to Conway.
I was talking about Conway today.
Yo, Conway, man?
He's nice.
Have y'all ever seen him live?
Yeah, man.
No. This dude gets on stage live with no hype, man, and just does it.
Kills it.
Yeah, he absolutely kills it, man. I saw him at the Paradise one time. Mm-hmm. And he absolutely destroyed it. It was unsightly, actually.
I think I've seen him thrice now.
Thrice? Wow.
Never been disappointed.
What was the first time you saw him? You probably saw him at the Middle East upstairs, right?
Upstairs at the Middle East.
And that's crazy, man.
Him
to
and
see.
Benny.
Yeah, man.
I can't believe I missed that shit. What year was that? Upstairs?
That was me, you, and Chucky, I think.
Yeah, that was like...
I missed that one.
That was like a year right before like the West Side Gun solo album, or like maybe a few months before that, and then like the next show sold out. It was crazy. I think we
the next show after that, it was downstairs and it was like shoulder to shoulder. It was like, okay,
I think I was talking about this today with Dro, and I said Conway is by far the best in Griselda. I think he's the nicest.
Yeah,
what do you guys think?
I think he's real nice.
I think I have to agree with you.
I think he's the nicest MC. I enjoy West Side Gun's albums more because that motherfucker is willing to just do outside of the box shit. You know what I mean?
And it sounds great.
Yeah, and I
like
love
this latest album. Again, yeah. Like it's mostly like, you know, featuring other people for the majority of the album. And I like that. I like other people getting the shine.
I want to play something for you guys. I want to play something for you guys real quick off the Big Ghost. I want you to listen to it closely.
What's that? The Big Ghost and Conway.
Conway.
The new
and
joint.
Then, and then afterwards, I got a question for you guys. Okay. So
we got
this.
Answers.
This one's called "Why You Ain't Move on Me." This is off the Conway and Big Ghost.
We back again, nigga. Look, from the city, niggas usually get wet for nothing. Keep the effing tucked and you can bet I'm a up it. Can make these niggas disappear, it cost me next to nothing. So you know if I press the button, you can expect the bludgeon. Threw my bitch to the bay, she left with extra luggage. I FaceTimed the dread, said you got extras coming. I never fuck with niggas, always trying to suggest they 100. Hitting agendas, I don't never trust them. Bought the bitch the present just to bust it. And lately I just been crushing on Vanessa Hudgens. Sketch the drums in, I paid the check. You can bet the youngest hitting chest and stomach by the next day before my breakfast done with. Million worth of jewels on me. If you don't like me, why you ain't move on me? Why you ain't move on me?
Let me say something.
Why you ain't move on me? You niggas spend too much time watching time flying by. Don't apply your drive, now you watch my Benz flying by. Niggas hit my line, but I'm like, why reply? Cause when I did need niggas, they left me high and dry. Don't do me no favors, nigga, I'ma grind for mine. Cook it up, settle ounces wet, don't give it time to dry. Remember stacking up my bread so I can buy a pie. Now I got a bag I can stand on and I'm a giant size. I've been feeling unfuckwittable lately. I got some killers that love me, so I don't care about niggas that hate me. They got switches and shit with no safety. And they gon' kill a nigga for me if shit getting hasty. Coming up, some of them old niggas didn't embrace me. Now they asking for a feature, but the price too high for them niggas to pay me. I told Big Ghost to send me some shit that's gon' take me.
This shit taking me, my nigga.
Machine, I swear. 2 million worth of jewels on me. If you don't like me, why you ain't move on me? Why you ain't move?
Know what it is.
Why you ain't move on me, pussy?
It's a lot of dead motherfuckers.
That motherfucker. I mean, the machine.
Yo, who did the beat on that one?
Big Ghost.
Nowadays, I'm laughing a lot. You're rapping a lot.
Sorry about that. That was loud.
Ouch.
I don't know that one.
But he had an interesting line on there, okay?
That is dope.
Dope. That shit was crazy right? Beat, right? And he dropped this line on here. I'm going to play it for you real quick. He did this on a freestyle as well.
In the dark, that shit really sparkle. I was at Diddy pool party, I ain't really hollow. They started to notice how hard the bars go. They saying shit like AC, you are a legend, but not the car though. These bum ass rap niggas can't even pay their car.
Alright, so you heard that, right?
Are you talking about the copyright line?
Yeah, okay. So then you
talk
have
about it. I have seen this.
Then you have the copyright line too.
Nowadays I'm laughing a lot, you're rapping a lot. Compare me to an accurate lot. They say AC, you are a legend. About to blow, don't gas him, he's hot.
That is okay. The exact same line.
I seen,
and that is a very, very fucking weird fucking line. Like that is.
Yeah, I seen copyright posting about this. We could talk about it.
So when
did Copy say that?
That was like 2000.
It was
like
a long time ago, right?
Yeah, it was a while ago.
Yeah.
That's 9 years ago.
So he had the Acura line, the
AC, you are a legend.
Yeah.
I mean, Jesus. But then Conway has the same exact line in that thing.
Yeah.
And he even has the same, like, cadence
same
to it. To it.
Yeah. Same.
Same rhythm to it.
Yeah.
He said it the same way.
The exact same way.
Yeah. So it's either he
hard to
it,
defend.
He bit it, but I doubt that, or he just, you know, came up with it. A lot of people.
But how many times have you heard something? You're like, oh, I wrote something just like that. It probably happens all the time.
It happens a lot.
I think it's definitely coincidence.
Yeah, I agree.
It happens with beats too.
Oh yeah,
you hear
samples,
something,
same
you're
samples.
Like,
oh, for sure.
I sampled that before.
Yeah.
Well, with lyrics is a little less Common. Because I'm a writer myself.
Right.
So I kind of, you know. But, yeah, that shit's coincidence. There's no, you know what I mean?
Because we played a one from a couple weeks ago. It was John Cena stealing lines from copyright, which I think they actually have a connection together, too. Yeah. So it's like I could see maybe that's why that could happen there.
Yeah, copy needs some money from that.
Yeah.
But would you guys as MCs feel disrespected if something like that happens, you know, like years after the fact, if you heard this kind of situation as one of your lyrics?
Someone take your line?
Yeah. I mean, I feel like you should.
You know, unless it's like homage, you know what I'm saying? Like kind of say and it's obvious nod, you know what I'm saying?
But you got to make it be known.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to make that be known.
Yeah.
Or you get them on the track, right? Or something like that later on.
Somehow.
Yeah, throw them on the remix or whatever.
Make it known.
Yeah, but supervisor. Same for you. Like 5 years from now and I'm calling myself the...
Yeah, if someone else came out with the Green Line Groper line,
yeah,
you know what I mean. Like, would you be like, hey, what the fuck?
Nah, but you know, to be perfectly honest, like I understand that like these ideas that are going around in my head are also like ideas that are just out there in the ether sphere. You know what I mean? And someone else could just grab a hold of it and go with it. So, but if the line is like too. If it's like just like what I said, then
too
maybe
close?
Then yeah. Exactly. If it's too close, then I might be like, all right, come on.
We can might question it. That's why we're questioning it.
Yeah,
it
exactly.
Is that close.
It is that close.
You know what I'm saying? That's why we're talking about it. So
that's why we're talking about it, yeah. Sure.
Also at the same time, like there's a lot of I could just mention Spicy. This. There's a lot of subconscious things going on. Like we listen to fucking rap every day.
Yeah.
And we listen to millions of lyrics and it's like those rhymes and those words are kind of just floating in your head. And if you're writing a rap, it might just pop in and you're like, okay, that sounds ill to me.
Yeah.
It might
you
be
might
some
not even
shit
think,
that you heard fucking 20 years ago.
Word.
Or whatever. Mm-hmm. And you don't know. You know
say
what
word.
Saying? It's just like,
yeah.
That sounds
facts.
Dope. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Sometimes it just pops in your head.
Yeah. And sometimes.
Subconsciously yeah. Just drifts
and sometimes
in there.
you might not know who you're paying homage to. You know what I'm saying? Like. I'm sure there's plenty of cool Keith lyrics that, like, I don't know, something that I dropped had a similarity to it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I know exactly what you mean.
Yeah. The illest thing about, one of the illest things about rap and hip-hop and, you know, writing songs is just the infinite, like, infinite combinations that you can come up with.
Yeah, and the infinite reinvention.
Exactly. Someone could say a line, you could maybe be saying kind of the same thing, but you're saying it a different way. And it's just like, there's infinite, like, combinations of words that you can put together.
You see that a lot with, like Wu-Tang affiliates. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's like, but it's like, I don't think, once again, it's like they're paying homage to something that inspired them greatly. You know what I mean? A lot mm-hmm. of the time, which I think is kind of dope. And then it all kind of coincides with one another, which is also pretty dope to me.
You want to delve into, who do you think is the best Killer Bees? Or, you know what I'm saying? You want to talk about that? Or
oh.
You guys probably talked about that before.
We haven't.
No?
I want to
nah,
do a
probably
whole,
not.
We want to do a whole episode on that because there's
yeah.
so much
you
to go
hold
down.
On to that?
No, but we can discuss
it
real
it?
Quick. Yeah, yeah. I mean, you got to go kill a priest, right?
That's a good one because there's a lot of shit you could talk about.
Hellraiser?
Yeah.
Right?
Hellraiser. Let's go top five.
Top five, Hellraiser.
Definitely.
Kill a priest.
Yep.
I'm not going to count Capadonna because he's a member.
Yeah, he's a general.
All right, so you got Hellraiser, Killer Priest.
One. I could throw one.
Go ahead.
Timbo King.
Timbo, that's a good choice right there. Street Life.
And I'll throw you one, man. It's Killer Sin.
Killer Sin.
Killer Sin, bro.
Is he gone now?
So
rest in peace,
no,
right?
No. He's alive. He's locked up for like his
okay,
whole fucking
yeah.
life. But
what about... Shaheem. How do you guys feel about
Shaheem
him?
Shaheem counts still? I mean, that was a long time ago, but
no, he's still out there. He's out there, bro. I like his shit when he grew up, like before he went back to jail, like the second time or whatever. You know
Street
what
Life, though.
Street.
That
yeah,
might be the
never,
one.
Street.
That might be, that
yeah,
might be the
but
one,
like,
though.
Well, let me he's nice on, like, features. Let's be honest.
Nah,
though,
man.
Like,
yeah,
Street,
we don't
though.
Know, but,
who's the other
yeah,
guy?
But still.
Who's
yeah,
the other guy who rolls with
Ghost?
Who's the other guy who rolls with
the way he shined on that Wu-Tang.
Oh, you and the guy.
Trife.
Trife the God.
Trife the God, too.
What about Remedy?
Remedy Ross.
Come on, man. Nah, I don't think he qualifies in that realm. I mean, Remedy's nice,
man?
But he don't qualify in that realm.
Yeah, Law of the Dark.
Law of the Dark, man, I think is the
height
top.
Height of the Century is actually.
Oh, wait a minute. How do we just overlook that?
And everything after that, too,
he's
has been
five.
Nasty, dude.
He's top five.
He's crazy with
he's
it.
Top five.
LAD, man.
Come on.
Yo, but let's talk about Height of the Century real quick.
Crazy.
That shit
fantastic
one of the
album.
Best Woo affiliate albums.
With the fucking, what was it? Well, on the cover, the purple fucking mask.
I know, man. Yeah. The purple mask with the eyes in it. Yeah. Jesus Christ, man.
Luchini.
That album was crazy.
Shit drops with Luchini.
Yeah.
Crazy, bro.
Man, Heist of the Century. I haven't thought about that in a long time.
It's an incredible album.
That's a real good one.
I mean, is that pull-upable? Is that on the streamers?
It might be.
It is. Yo, shout out. Let me just say this. Shout out Fourth Disciple.
Fourth Disciple, too.
He's one of the illest fucking. I say this a lot, and I post about him, but he's one of the illest.
Mm-hmm.
Producers to me, you know what I'm saying?
Just
listen
no,
to that album,
you.
Listen to that album, listen to the Killer Army shit, and listen to whatever BC had on the Wu-Tang Forever. You know what I'm saying? He had Better Tomorrow.
You got the Heist of the Century, which was produced by Muggs, too.
Oh, the title track, yeah.
Yeah,
no shit.
Speaking of which, we never got that Muggs joint that we were talking about.
Ah,
Freddie Gibbs.
Freddie Gibbs and Scarface joint.
Hold on
play
a second.
That shit.
We should play that. All hold right. on. Fuck this Heist of the Century crap.
But Heist of the Century is a fantastic album. But like,
let's get
up with the latest and the greatest.
You didn't have to disrespect her.
All right, so what we got at the top?
Did
five.
You wear
let's
a
just,
condom?
Let's solidify that. We got Hellraiser.
I liked War Cloud too a lot too when
ooh,
he was
Holocaust.
Yeah, Holocaust. Yeah. Smuggling booze in the graveyard. Yeah, that
yo,
shit
was
tight.
He was fucking ridiculous. So let's just say this: Hellraiser.
Yep.
Killer Priest.
Yep.
Law of the Dark.
Yeah.
Timbo, I put Timbo King. I don't know how y'all feel.
And I'm
Timbo,
a,
I think
I'm a Timbo King fan.
Incredible, bro.
I put his number in the rafters.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Based on that song, The Legacy.
And
alone,
so for number five, I'm gonna throw Killerson in there.
Killerson, I like it.
Yeah.
Heavily underrated.
Killerson's a good choice.
One of the illest spitters of all time.
In my opinion, Killerson, the best member of
Kill Army. By far. Shout out the PR terrorist because he's fucking.
Nah, all them cats are nice, but like,
Don
Pacino yeah,
is nasty.
But the top notch is Killerson, man.
Y'all ready for this Gibbs joint?
Let's go.
Throw it at him.
Let me get it.
All right, hold on a second here. Here we go. Street Made, it's called.
Yeah. I'm with the streets made, street raised, represented for the homies on lock a 6 feet grave. And these days it's a must you stay solid. The rules you should follow is either you get swallowed, homie. Now stand up, put your motherfucking hands up. This ain't no jack move, nigga. Pull your pants up. And man up, you out here looking like a dancer. JoJo shooting at children and that's a no-no. You up the 4-4, you better be ready for what's behind it. These niggas ain't playing, they come to find him. Now let the street lights blind him. Staring at his eyes wide shut, the way they did it was fucked up. But that's how it goes. 1 minute you 10 toes, and the next you hear a pop and you bleeding and out cold. These youngsters amongst us thinking they bout to bunk us, and don't realize that we the ones that got shit crunk up. If you a father, then you raise your son. If you a mama, pray those days don't come. Death is permanent. Ain't no coming back from that. You ain't the only one walking around strapped. In fact, they got guns everywhere you look. A potential kill alerts in every hand you shook. Yo, we did it for dope and the dollar signs. You did it for likes all on your lies.
Yeah. Surprise. What the streets made, street rage. Mama through LA fucking with B's and MC's. Stuck in the D game. I got different flavors of dope. Like niggas got weed strains. Wait till the rigor mortar set in. That nigga freeze frame. My blow came on a tugboat. Fitting on, got him comatose. Gotta watch these days. They can trace it back when a nigga overdose. Took his ass on the tour. When it came to rap, he was just a local hoe. Space rapping, nigga worldwide show. Sold out, don't both coast. Nigga, cold that shit. We jack these rappers. Why they y'all shopping? Nigga, let me hold that shit. Maybe if your jewelry wasn't so blurry, nigga could have sold that shit. Nigga came eight deep and still couldn't kill me. That was some hoe ass shit. They done forced my hand. I done made my plan, nigga, ready for the blowback, bitch. Gremlin like Kodak, bitch. I done bust that pipe, then I swipe that barrel out, then I sold that shit. I dig her down, she got potential, then I might mold that bitch. And I better not ever get prosecuted for nothing I told that bitch, nigga. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Mugs.
You got this bad boy? Jeez. What album is coming on?
I think it's on Soul Assassins 3. I think Mugs
we getting that this summer?
I think he's about to drop the new Soul Assassins album.
That's right. Crazy.
So you were talking about that beat change right there?
Mm-hmm. Fire.
Amazing. You know what I mean? I love it when a producer actually takes the time to just kind of like slow it down real quick.
Yep.
And then just flip you right back. And Freddie is doing this, like, he's doing that rapid rap a lot more nowadays. And is that like is it just like Midwest dudes that do that so well?
What do you mean? Like faster? Or
yeah.
Like,
I mean, almost on some Bone Thug shit. You know what I mean?
That rapid fire.
I mean, there has been a Midwest thing for a long time, man. I mean, from Bone Thugs all the way up.
They do it very well.
To Twista, to...
Some do or die.
Freddie got an ill rapid fire style to him. Like he spits fast and he can like catch an ill like rhythm. Yeah. He could double time or he could slow it down.
He
got
like,
an ill style because he can like he's very versatile with his flow.
But is he like upper echelon type rap now?
To me?
Just in general, do you think he's reached that peak that like everybody knows him, like household name type? Has he gotten there yet?
He's big. He's big. I'll give him he's big.
I mean,
I love that.
And
dude.
He's dope.
Freddie is an outlier. You know what I mean? When you think about like he's an outlier. Oh, well, because like going from being signed to not a major label, but like a major artist, you know what I mean? To being independent, to blowing up on some independent shit, you know what I mean? Because now he is like pretty much strictly on his own shit. You know,
no, you're absolutely
like
right.
There's only a couple of the cast. I mean, Danny Brown's a good example of that as well.
He's in that same wheelhouse. Yeah.
Exactly, because like
he blew up big time.
And also, interestingly enough, like he is kind of Midwestern, right?
There you go. Yeah,
he's a Detroit cat. He was signed to G Unit, dropped off of G Unit. That didn't work out, and then he managed to fucking build himself up and blow up to what he is now.
But I remember we
Freddie?
Were playing.
Nah, I'm talking about Danny Brown.
Yeah, was signed Danny a G Brown. Unit?
Yeah, he was signed a G Unit.
Yeah,
when?
Back in the day.
That's how he started, man. He started
way
off signed
when.
A G Unit.
No.
Yeah. Real talk.
Hell I don't know anything about
I
that.
I know, you never heard that.
I never heard that.
I know, isn't that crazy?
What do you mean?
It did
he
not
was
end
signed
well.
To G Unit.
What do you mean?
As like a G Unit rapper? What do you mean?
As a rapper for G Unit.
As a rapper.
But he didn't fit the mold at all.
Not even the same.
At all. Check.
Let me ask this. Was he, at that time, was he rapping like a Lloyd Banks or what the fuck? I don't
know.
Nah,
he was rapping
Danny
crazy
Brown.
Like a Danny Brown.
He was
but
Danny
like,
Brown.
I think 50 saw the potential in this cat and was like, boom, I'm grabbing you. You know what I mean? But not understanding that, like, there was no way he could make that work within the G Unit.
He can't
wheelhouse.
Do a song with Tony Ayo.
Nah, hell no. I
mean, he could do it with Lloyd Banks, though.
Actually,
Lloyd
he
Banks,
really
yeah.
could.
Could
I take
that
Banks. Back.
I, can see
that. I take that back. Toby
nah,
and
nah,
Danny
I mean,
Brown could be a dope trip.
Danny's that versatile. He could have done that, but he was like, this doesn't work for me. Like, I'm not about to just wear a bunch of baggy-ass G-Unit fucking clothes. Like,
was this around the time of G-Unit, like Beg for Mercy? Like,
I must
era?
Be a little later.
Yeah, it was later. It was later G-Unit.
Okay, after, because that album's fire.
Yeah, it's got some good beats
so
on it.
So after that.
Yeah.
Danny Brown.
Yeah.
Okay, I never heard that.
Danny Brown. Hey, listen, no man. Fucking Rock Marciano was in motherfucking flip mode.
Like, I know that. But that's
nah, but I'm just
shit,
saying. But
man.
That's that.
That's not the same.
But you can't imagine the Rock Marciano that we know.
Let's talk about it.
As
Let's
a member
about,
of flip mode.
I want to shout out the UN album. You guys know about that?
That's a fantastic album.
We listened to it a couple weeks
Let's
ago.
Let's fucking talk about it, bro. How nasty was Rock Marci in those days?
Crazy.
Crazy.
As a matter of fact, when we used to chat
Super
back
crazy.
In the day, before Marsburg came out,
mm-hmm.
Don Def was like, Rock Marciano, man, he's the dude.
Word.
Said it. That was like probably like 2008, 2009. Yeah. That's before Marsburg.
He called
I did? I said that?
Yeah, you said that.
Huh.
I remember. I don't forget anything.
That's what's up. Yo, he's been nice. Yo, honestly, I love the new shit, but he, like, when I think of, like, his hottest verses, a lot of times I go back to that shit.
That UN album.
A lot of times I go back to that shit.
You went
to
you out.
Because let
Executive
me say
produced
this.
Produced by Q-Tip.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And he had some P-Rock shit too. P-Rock beats. Let me just say this. When he was spitting more rapid fire, like faster, crazy. Now he slowed it down. It sounds ill. And
you
went
to
you
out.
You know what I mean?
And everybody took his style. Yeah. Everybody.
I like his, you know what I'm saying, that old that shit is crazy. Like, what they want, that song was fucking insane, bro.
I got a track for Jelani here.
Golden Grail.
Golden Grail, that's the shit right there. Grail. There's so many bangers on there, though. I got one for Jelani here real quick. Let me play another joint here.
That'll be good.
Naughty windbreaker shit, living dangerous, leaving all my op spaces with razor rips. Peep these niggas biting my staff, they go plagiarist, the bitches scream.
Turn this shit off.
When I played your shit, started out with one and then I made a six. The plug came through in the clutch, I got in gear and I made the ship. On the road to riches, that's paved with ill intentions. New money, my girl and thirsty bitches in my Twitter mentions. It's whatever, better forever, the motivation. Went from popular drug dealer to rap sensation. Weird shit got my so-called friends hating. Imagine if it was $1 million, how you niggas changed it. 96 naughty windbreaker shit, living dangerous, leaving all my op spaces with razor rips. Peep these niggas biting my staff, they go plagiarist, the bitches scream. When I played your shit, daily out for plays to make major chips. I swear hustling is like a stain in my brain. Nothing gon' change your shit. Criminologist, street economist. Now some shit I got from colleges. Consignment is like a scholarship. Points on the package till you buy your own. Time for the chronic, that's radioactive. Daily be my cologne. Live from the matrix, is your mind locked inside your phone? 5G radiation, they making the frying dome. No competition, it's just copy clones and mighty gone. Salute the vagabond. Life and times of a rolling stone. 96 naughty windbreaker shit, living dangerous, leaving all my op spaces with razor rips. Peep these niggas biting my staff, they go plagiarist, the bitches scream.
Turn this shit off
when I played your shit, nigga.
Turn that shit off. That shit's hot right there.
That's Rome Streets.
Rome Streets right there. Jelani, how you like that one?
Keep it coming, man. Any kind of music that sounds like that, that's right in my wheelhouse.
Rome Streets is ill, bro. I always big him up. I think he's one of the illest. I don't even want to say new. I mean, he is kind of new, but it don't even matter to say new. He's just one of the illest cats in the underground right now.
Yeah, he's nasty with it. Kung Fu's got a...
I'm looking forward to... He signed a Griselda, right? West Side signed him?
I think so.
He's dropping on Griselda, so I want to hear that shit. It's been a long time since that news came out, so I'm not sure where it's at.
Dro just sent me something. What's this here, Dro?
You got an exclusive?
Yeah, no, it's a song I do with Honest.
Ah, that's what's up, man. Yeah.
Hard shell.
Our man Honest, man. Hard shell cat.
It's called Be a Man.
Be a Man. All right, I like that.
Produced by me.
Like the Macho Man Randy Savage album.
Yeah. Be a man.
Classic rap album. One of my favorite summer jams right there, you know? Crazy. All right, here we go. I got you here.
You can act like a man, but you're out of here.
Sometimes I feel my situation worsening. I work hard, my work played to me and worshiping. I was raised up tough, it wasn't nurturing. I tried to point up my vibes, it wasn't worth a cent. My gun's so loud, it's blood curdling. Fiends in the hood, so the D's and start hurtling. Yeah, get low, sunny circling. Ain't swallowed the work, it burst, now we gurgling. The hospital failed, the docs turned the mini. Did a couple joints and came home, he took it on the chin. Hand in hands make me nervous now. Got me questioning my vision and my purpose now. The fear scratching at the surface now. I hope they hear the passion while the hash is getting passed around. We off the chain like a bass of ham. Somebody send the word, the boys are back in town.
I'm outside pulling licks.
I gotta do it for the fam.
I can show you how to fish.
But I refuse to hold your hand.
No fall for distractions.
Never change the plan.
Make it happen, be about the action.
Sign to be a man.
I'm outside pulling licks.
I gotta do it for the fam.
I can show you how to fish.
But I refuse to hold your hand.
No fall for distractions.
Never change the plan.
Make it happen, be about the action.
Sign to be a man.
It's going down like hell. Bitches wanna control us. Praying for me to fail. Act
acting different when I roll up. You don't understand, that's not real to me. Act like a man, I'm walking the earth fearlessly. I can take it light, but the work is never done. Shining brighter every time as I surface like the sun. Take it personal, with no rehearsal, I'm the one scraping up every crumb. I've been searching for the fun. Yo, I stay fly, ho. Charter me a flight, it's Northside Dro. And on it's on the mic, reppin' 617. Proper and precise, you can check the catalog. We've been problems all our life, take you on a cruise. From Ringer to Broadway, I got too much to lose, I can't parlay. The stress is weighing on me, I had a hard day. Stop playing with me, I ain't a RK. I'm outside pulling licks,
I gotta do it for the fam.
I can show you how to fish,
but I refuse to hold your hand.
Don't fall for distractions,
never change the plan.
Make it happen, be about the action.
I'm trying to be your man.
I'm outside pulling licks,
I gotta do it for the fam.
I can show you how to fish,
but I refuse to hold your hand.
Don't fall for distractions,
never change the plan.
Make it happen, be about the action.
I'm trying to be your man.
I could show you how to fit.
That was hot, Dro. That was fucking dope, man.
Good look, brother.
Wow. Be a man.
That's it.
That's honest the C- that, that, that's the CMB crew right there, man. Shout out Honest, man. Portside.
Shout out Honest.
Honest still doing his thing.
Honest to God.
Yeah.
Doing his thing.
Yo, I may have mentioned this earlier on the show, maybe a year ago, but I ended up my man Chairman Chow invited me to come up and perform at a big music festival up in Maine. And I went up there last summer, and Honest was there. And I hadn't seen Honest. I hadn't, like, gotten down with Honest in mad long, but that's my man since, like, fourth grade, you know what I mean? And we went up there, and, man, watching him get up on stage and do his thing, this dude is still, like, on. He's a top-tier MC. I'm glad y'all did a song together, man, because that's my guy.
He's nice. He rocked at the show when we did in Central Square.
That's right. Yeah, he came through and rapped there, but it was earlier before that I ran to him up in Maine.
Okay,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, but he ripped that show too. That was dope.
Shout out to Honest.
It's a nice summer show right there.
Port City. Yeah, that was a fantastic thing.
We should have did it again this year. I mean, there's still time. But
yeah.
Who knows?
But that was a big production, man. It was a lot of effort to put together a show, you know what I mean? To have the doppelgangers come through and have all the illest, literally all the illest MCs from around Boston come through and fucking perform.
That was dope. Good luck for you.
If he doesn't say so himself.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Best album of the year right there.
Nah, no shit.
Barry Horowitz.
I pat myself on the back 17 times over that shit. No, but really, I mean, that was the best motherfucking rap show of the year.
Yeah,
as far I think so. As far as Boston, shit.
Like, it was the only rap show of the year too. By the way,
there was a lot of other shit going on. You know what I'm saying? There was a lot of other shit that happened. That headliners came through or whatever. But it was like, you know what I mean? No one did that shit for free. You know,
that shit was hot.
Except for us,
Jelani and I had fun in there. We saw Dro up in there.
Yeah,
oh yeah. Saw Don Def in the place.
Hell yeah, goon support.
Jelani, you were just looking up some summer jams. What do you got here? I hate to get you back up. You just got comfortable.
Yeah, man. What are your top tier summer jams?
I was saying
guy?
Naughty by Nature, Hip Hop Hooray.
That's
a
good
big
one.
Big summer joint.
That's good.
I think Feel Me Flow was a good summertime joint.
Feel Me Flow.
Hear me. That's
damn, that was slapper. They were fucking shooting water in the video. That was a Boys and Girls Club slapper right there.
That might have been a Fidelity House joint. Right
yeah,
there.
Dude. That was
that's
was
that wet t-shirt joint.
That was a great fucking track right there.
Yeah, it was.
Feel my flow now.
I don't know.
I feel like TLC Waterfalls was another big summertime joint.
Yeah, for sure. You know what's ill? Talking about Naughty Nature?
Yeah.
Eminem always talks about Tretch as being his, like, favorite rapper.
Yeah.
You guys see that?
Yeah, no, yeah.
For real.
Always talks about Tretch.
After I heard him talk about it, I went back to listen. I'm like, actually, Tretch was on a different level.
He was on a different level, man. He was that nice. Mm.
But his wordplay was so different and so radical for the time. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, gee damn. Mm.
Gee damn.
Now, I remember hearing that shit and being like, let me go back and and listen to Tretch real quick and being like, oh, shit.
You know what was cool too? It's like
after hearing Eminem say it?
Yeah, after hearing Eminem say it and be like, damn, like actually, like I couldn't do that.
And shame on me. Shame on me for not hearing it way back when.
I know. I feel like we took these cats for granted.
We were but young, though.
Yeah, we were young, but it was still, it was like pop. You know what I mean?
Exactly. So, so popular.
I didn't look at it as like rap.
It was so popular that it was kind of like, that's why I said it was like, you don't really think about it because it was so.
Did you guys see that clip of Eminem talking about D.O.C. and then D.O.C. rolls up in the video? It's like another good thing like that, too. And then you listen to D.O.C. and you hear Eminem.
Like,
you know what I mean?
Yeah,
and it's like,
that's dope.
It's just like very cool, and it's like you don't even think about that, and then you hear it, and you go, "Oh, okay, this guy is like a real fucking student and fucking."
Well, let's talk about it. You know? That goes right back to Doggy Style. Let's boomerang back to that, because a lot of people say that D.O.C. wrote the shit.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't know if it's true or not.
I know he was in the studio. He was there. He did say he wrote some shit. I guess listen. Nope. I actually sent you guys a podcast, but it's actually hard to listen to D.O.C. because his voice is kind of fucking fucked up.
The theory is that he wrote a lot of Snoop shit on Doggy Style. I don't know. So,
but then again, you hear a lot of Snoop later, and it sounds exactly kind of, you know.
The same way.
Yeah, the same way.
Yeah.
You know, whether or not maybe D.O.C. taught him how to write, you know. Mm. Get that shit, you know.
Yeah.
You know, maybe he was like more of an unorthodox style and helped him shape that, you know.
Shout out to DLC.
It's crazy, man. I want to see that documentary.
I didn't watch the documentary.
Yeah, I didn't get to see it either. But that is so unfortunate what happened with him.
I know, the car accident and all that.
He actually had a voice we needed to hear.
He had a great voice.
Yeah. Great hip-hop voice again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I think going back to our conversation earlier, man, DLC is one of the top voices in hip-hop of all time until the car accident.
King T, another great voice in hip-hop as well.
King T.
About RBX.
Damn, RBX.
Man, RBX back was
deep. That was deep like the mines of Minolta.
Yeah. Now picture this.
Jelani, you had that tape back in the day, I'm pretty sure.
Yo. I wore that shit the fuck out.
That's the best album, bro. I put Doggy Style up.
What else you got for summer jams, Jelani? You think of anything off the head? I feel like the Eminem Marshall Mathers album came out in summer too, like right at the like the end of the school year, and it was like everyone was playing that. Bitch, I'm gonna kill you.
Which is okay, oh, so this is weird.
We skipped school for that. I remember that. We went to Tower Records.
Because the context of the music doesn't really
reflect
the time, of the year at all.
But
you
this is about your personal experience, my guy.
Hmm.
I thought we were talking about like how like fun. Album during the summer, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, I mean, it depends on who you're hanging out with, I guess.
So what if you're hanging out with just yourself?
If you're on the dolo, like an album for the summer, I would say is Lewis Parker.
Ooh. Oh, nice one.
Yeah. Look at you.
Masquerades and
the
first joint?
Masquerades and Silhouettes?
For real.
Fucking fire album.
Reminds me of like the beach.
I've been trying to buy that album for years. It's fucking so much money now.
I got that shit on CD, man. The original fucking.
That's worth a lot of money, too.
Lobster roll, extra butter.
You make me all reminiscent.
Lewis Parker.
Real, that's just a vibe.
Crazy beat maker.
Nah, man. Yeah.
Still
uses
the SP-1200, too.
Hey, man, if I had to pick one summertime jam, it would be called E-40. Sideways.
Sideways, E-40.
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to be too on the nose, but Lost Boys, Summertime.
Mm-hmm.
What about
that Lost Boys album is very summertime.
Do you have a Bone Thugs song you like to play in the summertime?
Yeah, every single one of them. But there are some, like, First of the Month has a good summertime vibe.
First of the Month, exactly.
It feels like I'm outside. We're about to have some fun. But I guess like you do like Big Pimpin'.
Definitely Big
Could
Pimpin'.
Could be a
that's,
good summertime
a
song.
One.
I got one.
There's that Dear Summer joint by Jay-Z.
Memphis Bleek,
that's
you mean?
That's a great one.
I mean, on the Memphis Bleek album, but he's not even on the song.
I got one.
What do you got?
Emmy.
Biggie Going Back to Cali.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You put that shit on and you're cruising wherever you're at, that
shit. That shit,
that shit will put you in the mood. Guaranteed.
I'm in the camera.
That Easy
Mo
B beat?
Yeah, exactly.
Easy Mo B?
Yeah,
let's just talk about Easy Mo B for a second.
Sick.
Easy Mo B?
We did on the producer.
Easy Mo B? I was talking to Dro about Easy Mo B today.
Crazy. Very underrated.
His beat slaps so fucking hard. We were talking about the SP1200.
Yeah.
Easy Movie is probably the number one most slept on producer of all time.
Dog, Ready to Die. All this shit, whatever he did on fucking
And
Life
all the
After
fucking
Death.
Tupac shit.
Yeah, exactly. He did shit for both of them.
That's crazy.
He did the what?
Yeah,
let's just end it with that. Let's just say that then.
Yeah, I'd retire.
Let's just say that. He made
just hang the
what?
Numbers. Hang the number up right there.
Have you ever heard the
Jelani, great shirt, by the way. Got the red fox here giving the finger. Just chilling. Amazing. What were you saying, Drew?
R.I.P. to the goat.
Nah, what's his face?
Easy Mo? We're talking about beats. SB1200?
Captain
Save-A-Ho?
No, not Captain Save-A-Ho.
I want to be saved.
Nah, he was the dude who, like, the first hip-hop podcaster. I forget this man's name. And it's disrespectful. That
Combat Jack.
Combat Jack.
Combat Jack.
Reggie?
So Combat Jack had this incredible fucking story about Easy Mo B, where, because he's a hip-hop lawyer, right? And he had some sort of story where there was, like, some sort of deal where he was trying to get Easy Mo B a ridiculous amount of money to do some sort of project. And he was searching out Easy Mo B, and this dude was literally out of his mind. Like, he, like, had the door barricaded and, like, would not let Combat Jack in to even talk to him. Have you guys ever heard this? Yeah, it's interesting. It's an interesting story, man. And Combat Jack is, like, basically, like, Easy Mo B was at the very height of his shit. Like, he had produced the greatest hip Tupac album, had produced the greatest Biggie album, right? The two top-tier fucking MCs of their time. And now he was, like, locked up. He had locked himself up in some sort of L.A. apartment. And this dude was trying to fucking knock on the door and get him to come out to sign some sort of contract, which is, like, a $1 million fucking contract to, like, produce for whatever was next, right? And he just could not get this man to come out the fucking door.
That's wild, huh?
Nah, because he was mad paranoid. He was, like, on some paranoid schizophrenic shit, according
mental
to...
Mental health issues?
Yeah, just wild mental health issues. Yeah.
He's probably just fucking making a banger. You don't want to go It's possible.
It's
Dro's
possible.
Been there before,
right? But this is the way that Combat Jack presented it. You know what I mean?
Combat.
But like, where is Easy Mo B now?
That's a good question.
I mean, I see him on Instagram posting
beats.
Yeah,
he's on his
1200. You know what I'm saying? He goes down.
He still uses the SP?
Yeah, I hope he gets his royalties because he made legendary beats.
Yeah,
let's talk about Ready to Die.
It's crazy, man.
How many beats did he make on that? Probably
seven.
The album.
Yeah. Probably seven or eight. Yeah.
He made the first track, the title track, Ready to Die.
Yeah, I was going to say the majority of the beats he made were like the most dominant tracks on that shit.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I think he did Me and My Bitch, too.
Yeah. He made Ready to Die, I know for a fact. I don't know who did Party and Bullshit. Who did Party and Bullshit?
Nah, but that's before.
But it was on the album, right?
No.
No, that was not Ready to Die.
I never made the album. No. Yeah.
I'm thinking about
it was on the Deluxe.
Machine Gun Funk.
He did make that beat. And it's funny, man, because Biggie wanted Machine Gun Funk to be the first single. And Puffy was like, nah, chill.
Made him do the other one, right? Big
exactly,
Papa, right?
Exactly, yep.
I think Puffy was right about that one.
Yeah, he was.
No, Puffy was right.
Yeah. I think that's a summertime joint,
It's a great album cut, though.
Oh, Big Papa.
I feel like that's a big summer
Juicy
joint.
Juicy is a
yeah.
We got to say that.
Let's man, because it's like you're just in that the mood.
Good. Honestly, summertime joint is anything that feels good, right?
We can't hear you because you're so far away.
Am I that far away? Juicy is a summertime joint. That shit makes you feel
Is that whole album a summertime album?
No.
Or just a couple tracks?
That shit's pretty dark.
Yeah.
Suicidal thoughts. Dark. But there is tracks on there that just go, you know?
I consider that more of a summertime album.
Life After Death is more summertime album than...
You think so?
More money, more problems?
Definitely.
Didn't it come out right before the summertime?
The
exactly.
Before you know, yeah.
You know what's funny,
too.
Man?
That feels like... Or,
going back to Cali, you know, you got that...
And this might be some Boston shit,
something.
Right?
Maybe
but I feel like
the Bone Thugs on there too.
I feel like it's easier to put my finger on wintertime albums than it is summertime albums, right?
Yeah.
Like
because we like underground shit and that don't. It's not
like
light,
Liquid Swords, fucking wintertime album.
Cuban Links, wintertime.
Cuban Links, wintertime album. Enter the Stage,
Cuban Links 2, wintertime album.
Wintertime album, right?
The Awakening, Lord Finesse, Wintertime album.
Wintertime album, exactly. But it's harder to find Summertime album.
OC?
Oh, yeah, Word Lined Life.
Up. Word Life or
Jewels.
That was a fucking fantastic album.
Mm.
And you think that's a Summertime or a Wintertime album?
For me, personally, yeah.
It's a Summertime or Wintertime?
For me, personally. Summertime.
Yeah. I fuck with that.
Yeah. I don't know about y'all, but I want some Dipset shit.
Dipset.
I feel like that's a lot of Wintertime shit, but I don't know.
It goes hard all year.
It could be any time of year.
Or like the Locks, you know, that I want to get. Like that shit, I think it's a summer banger too. I always think of like baseball.
Yeah, that was a fire song too. What's that other one?
What you got, Dro, man?
You know what I would say? Our summertime albums that are like kind of East Coast and West Coast are the Mass Days albums.
Ooh, Long Hot Summer.
Not even Long Hot Summer. I'm thinking more like Sitting on Chrome.
Yeah.
And Slaughterhouse.
Or Jeep one?
Exactly. Slaughterhouse is a fucking summertime album. And that's the East Coast cat who put out an album on the West Coast that's a summertime banger for the East Coast.
Okay, now you just sparked the memory. You know what I mean?
I got one.
Now
for
we're
you.
Talking about some Born to Roll.
Booming in your booming in your booming in your Jeep.
Like now we're talking something different, okay? That sounds great right there. Like now we're talking like my posse's on Broadway type stuff.
Yeah. My posse's on Broadway.
I feel like those are the different sounds I could hear in the summertime.
A summertime joint I like is What You Want Nine, Mad Beats with My Rhyme, What You Want Nine.
That's a summertime joint.
Yeah.
Who's that?
Nine. N-I-N-E.
Another great hip-hop voice, too, by the way. Incredible.
Nine, yeah, you hit on that.
What about Willie D, Bald-Headed Hoes?
Yeah.
What about that?
I don't know about that.
I know all about that.
That's the jam.
And right I'm not going to – I'm going to say that's a summertime jam.
Hey.
Let's – I got a topic.
It's all good.
Remember how hard he went on Grace Jones?
Yeah.
He really disrespected the shit out of
Does Ghost
Grace
have
Jones.
Any summertime joints, you think?
Oh, come
Pretty
on.
Tony.
Ghost?
Pretty Tony? The whole Pretty Tony?
Supreme is summertime all day.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You put fucking one on. Yeah. You put this, you know, title track. I got a topic. How about this? This is random, but I was listening to Exhibit.
Okay.
The other day, I listened to
which album?
I love Exhibit.
Three Card Molly is my shit, man.
Come on. Is
Plastic Surgery.
I think he's one of the best West Coast rappers in the game. Exactly. Yeah. The first album, Speed of Life.
Speed of Life is crazy, and then the second album is crazy too.
Paparazzi is fantastic.
But so, what's your point?
The foundation. No, it was just a random thought because a lot of people don't talk about Exhibit,
and but that's some good summertime shit too, man.
Yeah. And I think he's one of the
word. But that's the thing about these West Coast MCs is that their sick albums are our West Coast albums. Mm. I mean, I'm sorry, not our West Coast. Those are our summer albums. Mm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because it's always summertime out there.
Yeah. But Speed of Life was really
Speed of
dark.
Life.
It wasn't really
no Speed of Life, and the album after that was fucking amazing.
Mm. I just wanted to say that he's fucking underrated.
He is underrated.
It doesn't really fall in line with the summertime.
That motherfucker
vibe,
went ahead
a random thought.
And signed to Dre and did a bunch of kind of commercially stuff that people didn't really respect. You know what I mean? Like,
no, I think he did. He blew up.
No, he did blow up. But I'm just saying, like, motherfuckers, real hip-hop heads like the cats who we are here present with right now, kind of dismissed his later work. Mm. But his first two albums are so solid.
Yeah. He was incredible.
Yeah. He's and also his work with Alcoholics in general, man. Like,
I just wanted to give him a shout
out. Dude, the Licks?
Pretty much.
Come on, man. Yeah, shout out the Licks, man. Shout out Exhibit.
I got another summer joint here for you guys. And then I think we got to wrap it up here. But peep this. Here's one for you.
Came for my life, need to get in line. The suicide by cop sweater is on. Fucked up out my mind. The gun in my belt banished the voice yells out. Enjoy a summer in hell. Dead friends and family surround me where they found me. An apparent suicide out of bounty on my spirit. Higher than I ever been. Overlooking my weight. The closed casket. Cause I had took off the face. Cause I ain't never liked nobody staring at me. I'm feeling sappy. Made a few people sad but more really happy.
My crew standing there with shovels just grinning when the sun dropped and the grind stop us back to the living. Cause I ain't really think I go out like Kirk, did you? Beat Gigi Allen to the punch and do it at a venue. Popped out the coffin like Davy Blaine. I hit y'all with a decade of verses, I guess, for baby fame. You wanna plug? Stick this underground shit so far up your ass, you stutter now. Keep looking to cover. How the fuck did rap turn into Big and Pop karaoke? Back in the 80s, they been shipping, kept it very low-key. I know I'm speaking to less than 1% of the public, but this is for the people that cop movies and loved it. Y'all better hope I don't catch AIDS or the big C, cause the day they say I'm going is in the week, y'all come to with me. From the smallest of riffs to the biggest of beefs, I'ma be the first rap serial killer in the streets. I'm caught somewhere between a thug and intelligent. I bug off an elephant, ass and scrapped off the elephant along with the rest of the insect nation. No, standing there with bloody arms like it's a hallucination. This could be the last you ever know of I, cause my spirit and physical just can't coincide. Used to write patterns, now they write for themselves. If you ain't in the depths, step back when I'm lighting up L's.
I feel like the other one, too, Movies for the Blind, is a summertime album for me, too. I listen to that a lot in the summer. So good. Medicated, not Medicated Minute. Well, even the Smut Peddlers album, that goes hard in the fucking winter,
though. Yeah. The Smut Peddlers album is amazing, man. I'll throw this out there. Boss Hog Barbarians.
Oh, man, great.
That's a summertime album.
J-Zone?
Yeah. Yeah, J-Zone and self-titled. Self-titled. That's a summertime album.
What about that Porn Theater Rushers album?
Ooh, Balloon Knots there.
Nabo? Balloon Knots, yeah.
Nabo? Yo, I got a track with Nabo Rock.
Oh, really?
Play really?
That shit. What's that on?
It's on everything.
Is it streaming?
Yes, sir.
It's on everything.
It's called Two Bizarre Superstars.
Ah, yes.
That sounds yo, exactly what it
Nabo
should
Nabo
sound
Rock,
like.
Man.
Shout out Nabo.
Yo, he's a legend in my eyes, man.
Yeah. Me too, man.
I always loved that guy before I even got a chance to meet him. And
Catnip Fossils.
Yo.
Yo, Nabo Rock he's a solid ass dude, and he's a dude who's held it down for a long time, man, for the Boston hip hop scene.
It's not popping up.
I'm trying to find it here. Oh, you know what? I messed up. I got you.
Him and Mr. Jason, man.
So good, dude.
Yeah, for real, man. Like back in the day when it was like okay, like it was the Boston hip hop underground scene. It was Mr. Lift, mm-hmm. Acrobatic, yep. Esoteric, Virtuoso. And then there was
Porn Theater Rushers,
man.
Catnip.
And I was a huge fan.
ETU, baby.
Yeah.
What is that face? You just gave me the weird grin, Vega. What was that?
I was just thinking about the first time we heard Nabo.
That was trouble.
The first time we heard Nabo together in the car. We were both like, what the fuck is this? And then halfway through the song, we're like, this is the greatest shit we ever heard.
We were like, can we rewind the radio right now?
That shit's dope. Was it Catnip?
Catnip, yeah. We just heard the beat. We're like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah. Whoa. Yeah, that fucking beat.
You got that shit lined up?
I got it lined up. All right, y'all. This is the Hip Hop Heads podcast. We got Bonafide over here on the right.
Hey.
Northside Dro, where can we find you, man?
Find me on Instagram, Northside Dro.
Boom, there it is. Don Def, thanks for coming through. Where can we find you, man? You got SKILLSET that's out.
Yep.
You got the single with the Brick Records there.
Yep.
You got some other stuff coming through.
You know it.
We'll be playing that on the podcast when it comes
Sir,
through.
Hit me up. Hit up dondef.com and dondef in effect on Instagram.
There we go. And then we got the supervisor.
Yeah. Play a big supervision, man. Hit me up.
There we go.
The supervisor.
Where you at, sir?
Oh, I'm Vega. You can catch me out at the cryptonline.com.
You can't miss that motherfucker.
Everywhere. Vega the Chosen.
Is that your name on all
everything.
Platforms?
Yeah, you can find it very easy. I'm not like Kung Fu over here who's got 90 different names.
I am nowhere to be found. I will be under a weighted blanket as soon as everybody leaves.
My G.
I love you guys.
Have yourself
thanks for having
sauce.
Us over
Yo,
here, man.
Hey, I love you guys. For real.
Love you too, man.
Thanks for having us.
Family.
All right, here we go.
Nice.
Two Peace, bizarre bro. Superstars. Coming up. Favorite in that too. Oh, that sounds nice.
Hey, yo. Nah,
slapper.
1-2-1-2. Donnie, Don Def. When it comes to this rap, we got stupid bars. If you hear a dope track, just assume it's ours. Give us all the money, give us all the newest cars. Yeah, cause we the two bizarre superstars. When it comes to this rap, we got stupid bars. If you hear a dope track, just assume it's ours. Give us all the money, give us all the newest cars. Yeah, cause we the two bizarre superstars. Plenty fresh, not a penny less. You're a biter, my style you 8-bit.
like NES. Call it petty theft, I don't feel any stress. See you just arriving, but we already left. I'm the deadliest, ready, set, go. Mind on my money and we steady get dough. If it's all love, give me every XO. Then I'm chilling at the telly with a heavy set hoe. Let me get low, yo. Stay below the radars. My team's about to hit you with the fatal flow and great bars. I ate stars, now my stomach is a black hole. Brain is a Mac Pro, playing tic-tac-toe. Got that glow, we the supernovas. If you provoke us, get wet like super soakers. Your whole crew is bogus, dude that wrote this is too ferocious. I'm in the back with the Buddha smokers. When it comes to this rap, we got stupid bars. If you hear a dope track, just assume it's ours. Give us all the money, give us all the newest cars. Yeah, cause we the two bizarre superstars. When it comes to this rap, we got stupid bars. If you hear a dope track, just assume it's ours. Give us all the money, give us all the newest cars. Yeah, cause we the two bizarre superstars.
Tailor made for a king, the beat is so majestic. Majestic. It's only right I clown justice as I said it. I went off and left the earth while recording this. I'm not up on their radar, suckers check your coordinates. Some higher level, old wizard just like Orko is. Don cooked the beat, okay Hops, let's put a fork in this. My name is Nasty, that's what the N stand for. Fans making noise at the show, I'm who they cheered for. I'm levels up like Zeus's, dipped in different gooses. I top off a venue, they asking where the roof is. I'm stupid like a doofus. We both MC plus a couple dope producers. The scene these days is weak, skills are dwindling. I burn up the comp, kid, this fire need kindling. It's like I'm too advanced, no equivalent. Like Wonder Woman's jet, you can't see the plane I'm living in.
When it comes to this rap, we got stupid bars. If you hear a dope track, just assume it's ours. Give us all the money, give us all the newest cars. Yeah, cause we the two bizarre superstars. When it comes to this rap, we got stupid bars. If you hear a dope track, just assume it's ours. Give us all the money, give us all the newest cars.